Maybe for one of your birthdays, okay?
My birthday's February 11th.
Oof. That might be too soon.
Jesus Christ, what are the odds of that?
Maybe St. Patty's Day or something.
Yeah, we'll stop back up again.
No, St. Patty's Day is a Saturday this year.
I said, maybe St. Patty's Day.
Because you know why? I'm coming here
okay,
to the
parade. Okay, why don't we let...
I already know these. Of course I know these things. I have to know these
yeah,
things.
Yeah, of course.
A lot of people now, after you saying things about Marion,
yeah.
About her, you know, and you might want to hook up, now they're crucifying Dr. Filatov, saying that he did not do anything to your vision.
By the way, very very special day. 1 year ago today.
Well, now,
now
people are saying it's not working because you're finding her attractive.
We'd have a good time.
Anthony?
Sure, yeah.
Let me have a couple beers together.
Let me teach you something about women.
Beers.
Please?
Yeah.
It's not all about, you know, boobs and ass and stuff. Sometimes you have to look past that and see.
What, to the CD wall behind them? Where? How far past are you looking?
You have to look past that sometimes, and when you realize that someone has something to offer upstairs, it's not all about the big boobs and the tight ass and the bald, you know what. Right? There's more to life, Anthony.
Yes, there
take,
is, Opie.
Take that away from this show right now.
I wish there was something else I could take away from this show.
Look at the Marion there. With the, she's got the personality, the intelligence, the brains.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
There you go.
Mm-hmm. Forgetting
the toughness. So do I.
I think for the first time in my life, I could see past, you know, see past an ugly body.
Dude, shut the F up, man.
Hey, I'm going to tell you, we're good. We're Bill. I'm Bill.
You look good.
Believe me.
You look good. All
thanks.
Right. All right, ladies.
Good.
Thank you.
Yeah. I work out. I walk.
All right, ladies, we got to go because we got to check in with Stinky.
Okay.
Yeah.
So thank you, girl.
We said hi.
It was great seeing you, and thank you for
thank you once again.
Okay? Okay.
Thank you for letting us do that show for 15 minutes.
Oh, no problem.
It was a half hour, but who's
thank you.
Right.
Thank you, Means. Okay. Thank you.
All right, there they go.
Okay, guys, we'll see you next
thank
time.
Thank you, ladies. Okay. Thank you.
The retarded Laverne show.
Goodbye. There they go. There they go.
Bye.
Out in Z. There they are.
And Marion's a piece of ass.
Oh, Jesus.
Hubba hubba. Lady Di.
Yes, hi.
Your pants are down?
My pants are down?
Yeah.
Yes, they are.
All right.
Okay.
We have to do it. You know it.
God damn it.
Listen to the contrast. All right, Lady Di, if you will.
Yes.
Rub the phone.
Okay.
Hey, Duncan. Yeah, I'm not sure why that's the case. Like I said before, I'm new to streaming anyway, so I'm not sure about the notifications and how all that works. So I do apologize. I think I got it working, though. I'm pretty sure the stream should be good. The performance metric thing in Streamlabs is showing that it's good, so hopefully at least that should be fixed. So.
Sideways or up and down?
Who cares?
Okay.
And throw it out afterwards.
Poor goddamn
phone. Left or right.
Okay, you got that?
No. Rub it again.
You want me to do it again? Okay. All right.
Go up and down, push hard, and just do it.
Okay.
Yeah. What are you using the end you listen in?
Did you get that?
Well, are you using the end you listen in?
Yes, I am.
You.
Yes, I am.
Stupid.
Why don't you put the end of the phone you talk into,
yes,
and use that end to rub on yourself.
Okay.
And then
do you want me to do it one more time?
Second box and choke yourself with the cord.
You stupid. Yeah,
only if he goes first.
Lady Di, do you understand how this works?
Yes.
You have to use the end of the phone that you speak into.
Yes, that's it. I am doing it.
Now do that and rub up and down.
Okay, I will.
All right. Oh, God.
Hello?
Yeah, hello.
Yes.
Okay, now back and forth.
Back and forth. Okay.
Oh, my God.
Did you get that?
Damn swamp.
Watson, come quick. I need you. I'm going to smash my invention called the telephone. Damn me for inventing the phone, Watson. Damn me.
All right.
Oh, man. Okay.
The circular motion.
The circular motion. Hold on.
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Most painful.
Oh, God.
What is it?
Sounds like a raccoon's in the garbage.
All right. How is that?
You don't want to know.
Raccoon in the garbage.
Yay!
All right. All right.
Oh, my God. Okay.
All right. Our choices in commemoration of Survivor 2. Mangy Dingo, Koala Roadkill,
You guys are so bad. Go ahead.
Dust Bowl.
Okay.
And Aborigine Ass. Don't forget Michael's hands. After.
Any other guesses?
Michael's
Any
hands.
Other guesses?
Shut up. You're she just wrecked one of the best lines.
That'll be very funny.
Don't forget Michael's hands after he burned him in the fire. The skin hanging all over the place.
Alligator, crocodile, roadkill.
Go ahead.
All right. I'm going to say silly putty on the barbershop floor. No, I'm gonna say, I don't even know what to say. What was that?
Castro in a leg lock.
Jesus Christ, the skimmer after a Wookiee pool party.
Go ahead.
What are you sporting there?
You want to know what I'm sporting right now?
Not really, but
you don't even care.
Are you done guessing?
Somebody sounded like an old realistic walkie-talkie being dragged across the gravel driveway.
Come on, Chief.
Hey, Kimmy, you got a guess?
That thing has never been groomed. Anything in its life. It's never seen scissors, razors, trees,
all right.
Wax.
Kimmy, Lady Di.
Yes.
When was the last time you used that thing?
When was the last time that was used for the purpose it's supposed to be used for, except for waste removal?
Oh, man. Do I have to answer that?
Yes,
yeah.
You do.
It's been a while.
How long?
It's been a long time.
The cobwebs.
I don't think so.
Yeah. Yeah, she likes to ride on the doors laying on the ground in abandoned buildings. And the KY jelly for moments like this.
All right, how long? Give us years.
You want me to give you the years again?
Yeah.
Okay.
What smells...
Should I or shouldn't I?
What smells worse? Kimmy, after she was in the Outback for 2 weeks, or Lady Di after she pulled her pants down?
Lady Di.
That is not nice. That is not nice. Come on.
You're right. That's not nice.
That is not nice.
I'll
we are both very clean people.
Is it true that sprinklers just went off in the room you're in?
Hey, real quick, so just to make sure, no more lagging or stuttering or anything on the stream. Looks like it was my VPN causing the issues for some reason, so. But anyway, just want to make sure.
No.
All right, what do you have?
Yeah.
All right, do you want to know what I have?
Yes.
What?
Yeah. I hope he just hung up. Oh, my God. In other words,
who really cares?
All right, we'll wrap up the show next and tell you who won the best ass contest.
Cool,
finally.
Cool, thank you.
WNEW. Rich Voss in the studio. He came by with his new CD. You can go to richvoss.com to get this. Is it going to be in stores?
Yeah, I don't know when.
The show, the 2 hour show with when Bob Kelly and Rich Voss were in studio and they were just ripping on each other for like 2 hours straight. The one that started with Opie's story about how he almost got paralyzed on the beach or something. I can't remember. That was a great show. That was a legitimately good show.
All right. Jeffrey Ross. All right. Hold on a minute. What is going on?
What's
out
happening
there?
Outside?
Oh my God!
Hey Sam, I gotta ask Sam. I love asking the newbies. What do you think of this place?
I think it's insane. I love the heroin cart over here. It's great.
Yeah, you just like, and all the works are clean, so you don't have to worry about any disease.
I had no idea you guys did the show totally naked.
Yeah,
it's really liberating. It's nice.
You can, and we jerk it during a commercial break.
Oh, that's who that was.
Yeah.
Okay. She gave you lotion. I didn't
give each
know
other
what
a reach
meant.
Around. Whatever.
Yeah,
whatever
like,
it takes.
Yeah, like we would get naked in front of a black lady.
Sam is the 18 years old. Can you
19,
buddy.
19.
Is he 19?
That's legal in Vancouver.
19. Look at you.
Gave him a special permission to be in the Friars Club.
Oh, yeah. Really? Yeah. Special dispensation.
He has the balls of a 90-year-old man. That's
it's true. I sit down on the toilet right in the water.
They're very cute. Do you need little brothers?
Oh.
All right. Also, we have Earl and Monique. Monique, how's the... Are you getting a little buzz there?
No.
No.
Well, then we got plenty more where that came from. There you go.
That's why I drink 151, because, like, two shots of that and you're nice.
Well, let's calculate the percentage and just readjust the drinks accordingly.
I'm getting picked up, so.
Oh, you're getting picked up?
Yeah.
Who do you want to call?
I don't think any pictures or video have ever existed of a Stevie's mom or Marion's husband. Like, I know Stevie's mom actually went into the studio that one time when Troy Kwan tried to bang her, but I don't think any pictures or anything were taken, and even if they were, I don't think they were ever uploaded. I could be wrong. I might stumble on them one day. If I do, you guys will be the first to lay eyes on them. So the second, I'll be the first.
All the cops.
No cops.
Earl, yo. Are you still happy with Monique and yes. the situation you're in?
I am.
She's ready to dance for you in just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Let her enjoy the room a little longer. We got the couch. The place looks like a strip club now.
I just saw something outside. It just thoroughly.
Cheer up, Earl.
Earl just saw something outside. Imagine Earl, white as a ghost, out of fright. Nothing racial, just out of fright, of fear, because of what he saw.
Well, Daryl's right, hold on. Miles
we're saving this.
All right, like a strip club now. With Monique and yes. the situation you're in? She's ready to dance for you in just a little bit.
Mm-hmm.
Let her enjoy the room a little longer. We got the couch. The place looks like a strip club now.
I just saw something outside. It just thoroughly.
Cheer up, Earl. Daryl, hold on.
Miles we're saving this.
All right, what were you
we
laughing
have
at,
to
though?
Save it. No.
Can you give us a hint?
No.
I've never seen you laugh hard.
No.
Yeah, they were freaking out. I got a clue.
You're gonna need glasses again.
No, I know.
You're gonna curse Dr. Philatoff.
I know.
Fixing your eyes.
Wait, I know who's here, but why is it so funny?
Oh, no, just do what you're doing.
Keep going.
Do this. Hot girl, go with it.
No, we gotta bring him in.
No.
We have.
No. Yeah. No. Ed. Well, I mean, I would hate that picture too, right? If only because of the time that it represents. Her service in the homeless industry. Because I think, she denied ever sucking hobo dick. Even after the video surfaced of her making out with Romeo. It's Romeo of the Railroad. Like, I mean, it's crazy how someone can be in such clear denial about something that is so obvious that everyone knows. Crazy.
Have to, because Monique needs a little more time.
Come on, we're running out of time.
I swear to God.
You?
Nah, I'm fine.
Oh, yeah.
She's great.
I'm fine. Liquor does
and talk
not
for a second. Because I got
no. Please, God, no.
I'm not going anywhere. I'm just going to ask Ben something off air.
All right. Ben,
look at these executive calls.
I know. He's got to take himself off the air. Ben now
trust
giving Opie
producer.
Information. Yeah, I know. That's what you got to do.
You know what I'm saying?
All right, listen.
Trust in Rick.
No. Rick, I have to do it. I have to trust Ben. Ben said you have to do it.
All right, let's just do it. We're running out of time. We really don't have time to be screwing around not doing something.
All right.
Yeah.
So do something.
Rick, just
please,
open the door. Let's go.
It's the retarded Laverne and Shirley.
Oh, my God.
The retarded Laverne and Shirley have come down.
What'd you do to your hair?
Oh, my God.
Holy Jesus Christ.
You look like Captain Kangaroo.
Hey, it looks good.
It looks good.
Guys, please don't go. We're going to miss you guys.
It looks good. Yeah, so does hepatitis.
Oh, well, why? Do you have hepatitis?
No, I'd rather
you
have
look
it
like,
than that hair.
You look like, I don't know who that is.
You don't know you.
I don't know you.
And you will never know me.
I don't want to know you.
Since when do beach balls walk?
I don't know. You tell me.
All right. Look at you.
What's
you,
wrong with me?
You're birth control.
No, yeah, why? Do you take it?
Huh?
Do you take birth control?
Just looking at you. Oh, my God.
What?
What are you? You look like a Dr. Seuss character.
Hey, let me tell you one thing. You are when, Dr. Seuss when, character.
When guys go south, I either go, I won't eat here, I won't
you
eat there.
You are Dr. Seuss character.
No, get out of here. Look at you. I thought I had an overbite. What do you brush your teeth with, a paint roller?
Same thing you brush your teeth with, honey.
Okay, don't ever talk to me like that. Do you know who I am?
I don't want to know who you are, because you know why? I know, but you don't sound very funny.
I'm not funny.
I like
right
your new face.
Okay. I mean, I had to find, I couldn't find the exact spot in the supercut, so I just pulled up the video from the Tristy Puzo and A channel, but, I mean, and we'll get to this eventually.
Here's, I guess they're interviewing one of the homeless.
But I had to watch
before
again
Lady
now.
Di showed up.
Yep.
They lucked out. They went to where Lady Di supposedly, you know, lives and stuff. She wasn't around.
Throw me over the railroad.
She showed up. But first, it's an interview with one of her homeless friends.
I've known Lady Di for over 20 years, but at this time she has drinking problems. She's an alcoholic at this time.
Very plorable.
And how long has Lady Di been here for?
Approximately a month and a half. Her living conditions, as you can see, are plorable. It's very plorable. Sad and very plorable. It's
thank God they're not deplorable.
She had a child by one man who jumped in front of a train and killed himself. A friend of Lady died.
A friend of Lady dies.
Plorable meaning more than one.
Right. There are two rails on the train tracks.
An alcoholic and a hobo cumaholic.
How are ya?
Whenever you walk in, they would play that stupid Hardy face.
That is one of the funniest ongoing jokes in this entire thing. Is the Oliver Hardy with the music and the train coming behind her as the music's playing. So like you just imagine Lady Di, Oliver Hardy, like walking, like happily trotting down a railroad track, and she's just oblivious to the train that's barreling down on her. Just focusing on her mustache and on Natty Ice.
Well, meaning more than one.
Right. There are two rails on the train tracks.
How are ya?
Whenever you walk in, they would play that stupid Hardy face.
Oh, that's fucking funny. All right, we gotta get back to the video. There we go.
That you know of. I mean, you know.
Six total. About six.
Three.
About six. Lady Di is gonna kill us.
Three, I know of for sure.
Three, you know of for sure?
Yeah.
And then there's
I know six.
You know six for sure?
Yeah, the clip with Patrice watching this and making fun of her. Lady Di walking the streets. Oh, shit. It is. Tomorrow is April 1st, April Fool's Day. Happy Fool's Day, Diana. Happy Fool's Day.
She knows. I know. Yeah. He tells her. More.
I know more.
Did you use a condom or?
Yeah. Yeah, she got dried and wet.
I could have swore. Maybe I always meant to cut out that part to trim it down when he goes on about his sister, because that was like 4 or 5 minutes long, I think. I guess I never did. Yeah, no, I always skip that too. Because it's not because of the subject matter, just because it's taking away from Lady Di. You know what I mean? No one interrupts Lady Di.
So you would say it was good? Better than good? Or outrageous?
Oh, great.
You would say
we broke the bed.
You broke the bed?
We broke the bed.
What do you mean? Wait. What the fuck was that?
That sounded like Lady Di.
But
there she is!
There she is!
Lady Di!
Takes her down with pitchforks.
their pussy has arrived.
Yeah, I know. Their chick.
What happened?
She's the only girl.
This month, maybe? You know, but...
Of the railroad.
Romeo the railroad.
Ah, here we go.
So how long have you been, staying out here for? Since, last month, maybe? You know, but before that, I've been homeless since November. Oh, Anthony, please, you gotta help me out. You have to help me out.
What a bum.
I don't know how much longer I can live like this.
Who is she looks like Trump here. How crazy is that? Sorry.
Romeo. They call him Romeo of the Railroad. I could live like this.
Who is the Romeo of the Railroad?
No, they call me the Romeo.
They call him Romeo of the Railroad.
Romeo of the Railroad.
Romeo of the Railroad.
Romeo of the Railroad.
Are you two, you know, intimately involved with each other?
Oh, God.
On a mutual, on an adult basis, you know, not anything nasty or anything. But... He's been keeping
like adults will, right? Like...
You've had sex with Lady Di?
Yeah. Yeah. Romeo the Train Cat.
There goes Romeo
on
the railroad.
There goes Romeo
on
the railroad.
There goes Romeo on the railroad.
There you go.
Obviously, they're making out at that point.
All right, I want to listen. There's more to the video. I forgot about that.
She's filthy.
I mean, we only came here for...
Like it almost looked...
Shit, sorry. We only came here for Romeo the Railroad, but... This whole video is... It's crazy. Let's see.
Hey,
how much was the rent?
Because, like, we're not going to get back to this, like, you know, on a regular... You know, if I'm trying to do the supercut from beginning to end on the live stream, we're not going to get back to this point for a while, so...
$1,000 a month.
How much are you making it on your donut thing?
$6.15 an hour.
It came out to
about maybe $200-something a week. More.
No one was able to help you out. Parent, dad, Lady Marion, or.
No, Marion did help me out a couple of times.
The earlier Marion was here, and you two were in a fight. Is that true?
Right down the stairs, man.
She was fighting with me. I'm not fighting with her.
I mean, be honest with us, because we're talking.
She turned around. She told me I put myself in my own predicament right here.
You're saying you didn't?
No. Can I?
Was drinking an issue also that I took up a lot of your money?
Nah, I don't know.
How much are you spending a week in alcohol?
I don't know. Should I be honest about this?
Absolutely. Be honest. Yeah.
Okay, $10 a day.
$10 a day. Drugs and alcohol, $10 a day. Yeah, the guys in the video, taking the video, were kind of douchebags. But I mean, but I mean, it's also Lady Di. And like, you want to feel bad for her when you see shit like this, but then, you know, if you know her already, or, you know, or if you don't, and then you stumble on a clip where she just refuses any and all help. Then it's like, yeah, the guys are douchebags, but you're not really upset at them because they're being douchebags to this thing, you know? John chugs a wine. Yeah.
On alcohol?
And alcohol.
I don't know. Should I be honest about this?
Absolutely, be honest about it. Yeah.
Okay, $10 a day.
On alcohol?
$10 a day. Drugs and wine every day.
Drugs and wine.
$10 a day.
Is that why you lost your job? Because you're drinking?
No. No, I just...
She had a very good job at the Budweiser factory before she got fired from that union job because she was on the phone yapping about her divorce on company time. Or wait, was it her back and they fired her because they didn't want her to sue them or something? I could never get it straight with this lady.
Just decided not to go back. That's all.
That's all. There you go. $10 a day for drugs and alcohol.
That means it's more than that.
Yeah, that means it's more.
She's not using probably the best stuff. She's not sipping cognac.
No.
Yeah, but even if they say wine, it's 15 or 20.
No, she said, well, she said drugs and wine. I think Anthony just said jugs of wine right there.
Wine, so she's getting those big jugs of wine and just sitting there.
Are the best stuff.
Yeah, he's thinking, I always thought it was drugs and wine.
I don't know. Should I be honest about this?
Absolutely, be honest about it. Yeah.
Okay, $10 a day.
On alcohol?
$10 a day. Drugs and wine every day. $10
drug?
A day.
Huh.
Absolutely, be honest about it. Yeah.
Okay, $10 a day.
On alcohol?
$10 a day. Jugs of wine every day.
Wow. Actually, holy shit, she actually does say jugs of wine, I think. Not Jimmy Stewart, I think you're right. Yeah, no, I think it is jugs of wine. I always thought it was drugs and wine because, yeah, exactly, Kay Brennan. I'm pretty sure she was smoking crack around this time, right? Huh.
Day.
That's crazy.
I don't know. Should I be honest about this?
Absolutely, be honest about it. Yeah.
Okay, $10 a day.
On alcohol?
$10 a day. Drugs and wine every day. $10. Should I be honest about this?
Absolutely, be honest about it. Yeah.
Okay, $10 a day.
On alcohol?
$10 a day. Jugs of wine every day.
Jugs of wine every day. Jugs of wine.
$10 a day.
That's crazy. Good catch, whoever called that out first. I think, Duncan, I think that was you. Jugs of wine. Yeah, good catch.
No, I
always thought it was drugs and wine.
That's all.
That's all. There you go.
Which is stupid anyway, as if alcohol isn't a drug. But that's crazy. Man, still learning new stuff about this lady.
As the homeless guy grabs her ample ass.
You know what's sad is Norton's going to pull up tonight with sunglasses on.
Yeah, and it was revealed by some dopey caller. He's just like, hey, Diana, when was the last time you smoked crack? And just nonchalantly, about 3 years ago. What? All we had to do was ask. All you got to do is ask.
Yeah. Is Lady Di around? I got a jug of wine. Here we go. She explains Budweiser firing.
Oh, here we go.
How did you lose your job with Budweiser? Come on, be honest. Tell us the truth.
That's a really jugs, soft issue right
jugs
there.
Of sangria.
Soft. I had a job 17 years.
I know, and it hurts that they fired you. Why? Let your story be known. Did you mess up?
Because I had a...
the Juliet of the railroad. I really want to make... I'm just going to do it. Well, I want to make a joke about it's too bad that it didn't end the same way, right? But I just thought of it, so I don't have the wording down on that joke yet. But there's something there.
Back pain. I went to see the nurse, and when I went to see the nurse, they decided, instead of me seeing the nurse, they decided, okay, she's going to sue the place, and to just say bye bye. And when I went to see the nurse, they decided, instead of me. Because I had a back pain. I went to see the nurse. And when I went to see the nurse, they decided, instead of me seeing the nurse, they decided, okay, she's going to sue the place. And to just say, bye-bye. That's it.
That's the reason they fired you, okay?
Apparently, she's a union worker. And she gets fired because, I think, you know, they brought it up. If she was in a union, they wouldn't... then she was the shittiest worker ever if they actually did fire her because of that. But, I mean, it's Lady Di, so, you know, we literally will never know for sure why she got fired. We can only surmise things from the evidence that we have, but we'll never know for sure, ever. It's a mystery greater than that of the pyramids. I don't know if she's still alive. I honestly have not heard any update on her that I can remember, anyway, that was an update after that final phone call when she thought she was in the Navy. I don't know if she's still alive. I hope she is. I hope she is still alive, and I hope the nursing facility she was in, you know, I hope it was effective, and I hope it helped her. Because I'll, you know, like to make jokes, but, and as worthless as she is, still a human being, and she's not, you know, she wasn't ever like, I was going to say like she wasn't ever outright abusive, but then like she was neglectful to her kid, which is like a form of abuse, so, But and I don't know. But that's the thing about Lady Di. That's the thing about her. Like, you want to see her die, but you also want her to want to see her succeed at the same time. It's fucking weird. It's a weird feeling.
How'd you clean yourself up? I mean, you have showers, you have...
2 days ago, I took a shower at my dad's house.
Yeah. Oh, Duncan, Natalie, I would say not only was she coming to work drunk, she was keeping her buzz going with company product while during the day. You know what I mean? I think it was Anthony made a joke about that later on. Like, they noticed you were no longer there when full bottles of beer started coming through on the line or something. It's a joke, but I actually think he was onto something there. I think she was definitely at least keeping her buzz going while on the job.
Yesterday, I took a shower. Not really a shower, but I washed up over a friend's house. Which he's not here right now. They talked to him on the phone yesterday.
Frank? Okay. So, are you romantically involved with Frank?
Sexually
no.
involved?
Sexually involved?
Well, you know what? Everyone is human. I don't know.
Not you.
Not you.
I don't like her explanation.
Oh.
The Budweiser. Yeah. My back hurts. You're fired.
You're fired.
Yeah.
Why I oughta. I heard stories. I don't know if they're true, but rumor.
I heard of a guy named Albert. I think Alvin was his little brother. And
Albert?
Albert.
Who was
Alvin
that?
Einstein.
I don't know.
That old bit.
Thank you. Hi, hon. Can you spare any change, please? I'm homeless. Any change?
Hi, hon.
What are you trying to get? Something to eat, something to drink?
Trying to get something to drink.
Baby Di,
we'll
get whatever you need.
Thank you, baby doll.
How's it
going? You
too
much.
Hun.
So she's standing out in front of a convenience store panhandling.
Acting it up.
What
do
you
way?
And the all guy right, was like, you know, right,
video's
what
old.
Is it?
Who does?
The cops.
Why?
Because that's what they do. They
yeah,
scare
but
the
have the cops hurt you?
No.
Have the cops mugged you on the railroad tracks?
No.
Who has though?
Else.
The guy who's supposedly your friend?
Yeah. Please help me out. I gotta get out of these streets. I have to get out of these streets. That's all there is to it.
Bye.
If you needed to get out of the streets, you would have fucking done something about it. Here goes Julie out of the railroad. Alright. Back to our regularly scheduled monster programming.
Clay, and I
good.
Like Jay Moore.
Good.
But you don't sound anything like
two
them.
Two washed-up hacks.
No,
yeah.
You look like you're washed
yeah,
up.
Yeah, so does your hair. It looks like...
Hey, my hair looks better than yours.
It looks like a perm with AIDS.
You look like you need Rogaine.
I was a crane operator. I'm sick of it, Diana. Bill was a fucking character.
Soon, honey.
Listen, just sit there and look
I'm
funny.
I'm not sitting in it. I don't have to sit and look funny.
Okay.
I can look at you, but
da,
you
da,
don't
da,
look
da,
funny.
Da.
That clip when they just leave her on the air for like 10 minutes at the end, just silence, and you can just hear Bill in the background yelling at her and berating her. And then she's like, what was it, a squirrel? Like there's silence, and then you just hear, ah! Get out of here, squirrel! Or something. This fucking woman.
Hey, I came up here to say goodbye to Whoopi Nancy. I didn't come up here to listen to you, because you don't sound very funny to me.
Yeah, well, that's wrong. You were going to listen to me.
I'm not going
to
listen to you, because you don't sound too funny.
Oh, you talking about Ponytail Ron? Ponytail Ronnie, you talking about Ponytail? Is Ponytail Ronnie?
Just say crunches. He didn't mean Nestle's.
Let me tell you one thing, honey. I lost 8 pounds in the last month.
Is that Ponytail Ronnie from the liquor gallery on Elmore Avenue?
Yeah. Hey, it looks
yeah.
like you found him.
And you gave him your hair.
No, well, let me tell you one thing.
Right,
I'm only
Marion.
You seem like
Marion. Marion, the hair's nice. All it needs is a face mask and some Dallas Cowboy stars on the side.
All it needs is a rock in it.
I'm telling you.
But it looks
I hope
good.
Tomorrow, You ain't here, but I hope Opie's here tomorrow.
Marion,
looks good.
Marion, I
looks
good. Marion, I'm over here. I,
you know,
I love your new look.
I know.
Thanks. Hey,
you look lovely.
It looks
8
good.
8 pounds down.
8 pounds down. Look at that.
I'm still going down.
50 to go. Very good.
It looks good, Luke Skywalker.
Jeffrey Ross. Jeffrey Ross.
Hold on,
Marion. That's Rich Voss, who's been on our show a lot.
I don't know him, so.
All right, and this is the talented.
Van Hammersley, Von Hammersmark. I was talking about that earlier. When Bob Levy, unironically, legitimately lost the debate, the babble debate with Marion. That's hilarious. Unfortunately, that's in part 5. So, unless you want to go actually, watch it, then it'll be a year till we get to it on the live stream. Go through on this, but I'm constantly rewatching clips from this all the time anyway. I don't know. For as much as there's something wrong with Lady Di, there has to be something wrong with me, and for all of you, for that matter, there has to be something wrong with us to care. I don't want to say care about this person, but just to be intrigued by her, I guess. I don't know. There's something wrong with us, man.
Jeffrey Ross.
Hello.
This is the retired Laverne Shirley.
Really nice. I don't know why you're doing with that guy. That guy sounds like a real goofball.
I am a nice guy.
You do. He sounds like a real goofball.
I have a reputation for being a sweetheart.
Oh, yeah.
Yeah.
What?
What's your name?
Sorry, I keep pausing it. The lines are pretty good. Not Jimmy Stewart. Cough syrup, normally I don't condone drug use of that kind, but when you're watching Lady Di, when you're listening to this lady, everything's fair game.
Are you the retarded Laverne or the retarded Shirley?
I'm the Shirley. She's
the
retarded
Laverne.
So,
now,
Laverne.
I thought you...
I'm a little bit more like...
Marge Simpson-ish?
It's like the cover of Retarded Frampton Comes Alive.
It's like... You know what I mean?
Talk. You know why?
It looks like...
David's okay on his own, but when they did the David and Bobo show... Oh my God, that was amazing. That was gold. David and Bobo and me, Stalker Patty. I said this the other day, but Stalker Patty, she is way too wholesome to be associated with this radio show. That poor woman.
We're train guys, right? And we walked here from the train station.
You know what?
Next to me.
Which one's the little one?
You are a train
Marion.
Station. Let me give her some airtime.
Marion.
Could you imagine? Hey, look at that cab.
She's
getting out of that cab.
Me,
Jeff, if you and her had kids, they look like hush puppies.
Yeah, she's telling me she wants to talk. So.
Oh, my God.
Holy Jesus.
She can talk?
Oh, man, I want to put a sticker in
there. How you guys doing? I hope
dust.
You guys do not leave.
Whatever happens.
That's all I have to say.
Thank you, Kathy Bates.
I could be Norman Bates.
Seriously, are you guys on the Far Side, that cartoon in the newspaper?
When did they finish filming Lord of the Rings? A couple extras.
Oh, my God.
We don't have time to read a paper.
You look like a before and a before picture.
We read the article today in a post.
Oh, my God.
Hey, Marion.
About you guys.
I think what they're trying to say, your perm, it's a little tight.
It's not tight.
Maybe it's got to loosen up.
It's got to loosen up a bit.
You had it done a couple weeks ago.
By who? Cousin
Who did it? Who did it? Lawn doctor?
Let me tell you one thing. My hair looks better than your hair and your face and your butt put together. I'm going to say butt.
What was that about Lady Di and Bobo? What's going on? Oh, no, I didn't copy it at the current time. God damn it. Here we go. Okay, Lady Di. Look at that. Lady Di and Bobo. In a passionate embrace. Look at that. Look at that.
Why do you wear that?
There you go. Whatever. Here we go.
Because I keep on having accidents.
Look at that. Look at that. I don't want to pause it because of the stupid overlay. It doesn't go away when it's paused, but... Ugh. Bobo. What? Okay, wait, where? Oh, here we go. Say,
and I'm rubber, and your face is spoon.
Oh my gosh.
Hair by Chia Pet.
That's the same thing from anybody, I'll tell you that. You can't hang with me.
You know what? I don't even drink anymore, so I...
What?
I love you guys.
I drink water now.
Hey, Mary, I drink water.
You two. Balthius did. Balthius had some drinks.
What is it? Right from the train station.
Hey, Marion?
You can't even say train station.
I saw a train station.
Hey, Marion?
What?
You lost the 8 pounds. I noticed you lost a little in the boob region. Yeah,
that's why I lost a lot of it. Up here, back...
Yeah, oh yeah, I lost 8 pounds. Yeah, I've lost 8 pounds in 13 years. But I walk on the treadmill for 5 extra minutes a day. I drink an extra bucket of water that my owner gives me on the farm that he lets me stay at. I've lost 8 pounds over 13 years.
How about a wow?
Not me. Not me. I don't wow.
Are you kidding me?
Oh, my gosh.
Wow.
Married. I don't wow.
Wow.
Diane
wow.
Wows.
Who's your husband?
Diane won't wow either.
No.
You're married? You're married?
Yeah, I am married.
Who's your husband, a blind donkey?
My husband's not a donkey.
Oh. My husband's
my husband,
not a donkey.
I'm sure he'd kick you right in your butt.
Her husband's not a donkey.
You're married? You're married?
Yeah, I am married.
Who's your husband, a blind donkey?
My husband's not a donkey. Oh. And if you met my husband, I'm sure he'd kick you right in your butt.
Not like he did
hey,
your
I still
hairdresser.
Love you guys. Okay.
No, this has been a pleasure. Her shirt says Lady Di.
Doesn't her hair look like Oscar Gamble saw the burning bush?
I do something with mine. See,
burning
I do
bush.
Something with my hair. But you
what,
look like
it?
You're losing yours.
Oh, my gosh.
Shut up, Diane.
Leave him. During
then you say
hey,
something to him then if you don't want me to
hey,
bust his
during
track.
Orgasm you go nah.
That's me.
Oh my god.
When you go like this, do you go eh?
No.
That's the universal sign for whacking it. Very good.
Hey,
Marion's comebacks are the best. Take notes.
Right back to him.
Oh yeah.
You're doing great.
Call your hairdresser, tell him it's totaled.
Call your hairdresser, tell him you need a new haircut.
What's the deduction?
No, you call your hairdresser.
Let me tell you one thing. I like my hair the way it is. It was like this 5 years ago.
Nobody
has to live with it except for me.
Look at
and I like
except
it.
Yeah, this is Bobo. Mr. Balloonigan. His name is Mr. Balloonigan. This is the fugitive of Mr. Balloonigan.
You and Sam Adams. Remember what
I don't drink.
We're over here. Put the good eye on us.
Oh, my
gosh. I don't drink.
Oh, my gosh.
Go ahead.
Hey, Lady Di, what?
It's for the show. It's for the show.
All right, wait. Lady Di.
Yes.
What seems to be the problem over
there's
there?
There's nothing over here. I'm just saying that I'm going to miss you guys.
You're a little distraught.
That's what you should do. Lady Di.
Oh, Jesus.
That's not nice.
No,
that's my nickname. It's been for years.
Marion's my favorite character in Lady Di. She's got a lot of hit points.
You look like out-of-work field hockey players.
I'm not out-of-work. You look like you're an out-of-work...
Okay, so I interrupted a Marion comeback. Sorry.
That's my nickname. It's been for years.
Marion's my favorite character in EverQuest. She's got a lot of hit points.
You look like out-of-work field hockey players.
I'm not out-of-work. You look like you're an out-of-work washed-up comedian.
No, I'm not.
Comedian. I'm not an A. But you're not
You look like you're a washed-up rhinoceros. A sea...
Fuck, man, I'm not going to continue with that. I was just going to pause it so that I could do the Bobo voice to say, Schnoodle. He's a Schnoodle.
I'm a comedian.
B-minus.
You're not an incomedian.
Yeah, I'm not an incomedian.
You're good.
Thank you.
I'm glad you like him. I don't.
I
don't like his impression.
Of what?
You don't have any impressions. That's why.
Oh Jesus.
He's an idiot.
Yeah,
you
don't like hold his... on. She doesn't like his impressions because he doesn't have any impressions. Marion, she has the best input.
I don't like his impression.
Of what?
You don't have any impressions. That's why.
Oh, Jesus.
I know. He's an idiot.
You don't like his impression?
You're doing
an
idiot.
You do an impression right now.
He's an idiot.
You're an asteroid.
You're an ass.
Holy
ass.
Right now.
Are you Jeff Norris's mom?
No.
Oh, my God.
Are you Jeff Norris's brother?
Oh,
my God.
Wow.
Come up with the quickest...
Yeah, I was gonna run around the building, but then E-Rock and Sandy ran before me, and I couldn't run around the building, right?
I'm trying to do it for the show, right? Yee-yee party, Lady Dog, Lady Nye.
Lines?
Oh,
Pink.
Very good.
Frank,
you know
that. Okay. All right. Hey, ladies, what do you think of the talented Monique over there?
Very nice. Hi, how you doing?
Jesus Christ, this is some show.
Oh, my God.
Someone will probably beat you up in high school.
Monique. Oh. Let me tell you, kids probably beat you up in high school because you look like you've been through a lot.
Shut up, you stuttering hump. Yeah. Probably takes you a week to
whatever,
stop
up. Who is that? I know you've been...
Rich boss.
I know, right?
Focus.
I keep forgetting because I don't want to remember who you are because I don't want...
I still got to work on the voice, though. All right. I really think this Bobo voice will get me to the top, all right? I'm not lying. I'm not lying. I do have to work on the voice.
On the voice, though. All right.
I want to see you.
All right. God. What about Jeffrey Ross?
I think he'd be okay without him.
He's the king of the roast.
I like Jay Moore and I like Andrew Dice Clay.
Wow.
So that's who I like.
And who's your third? Carrot Top?
No.
Howie Mandel?
No.
Ugh.
All right.
I like these ladies. I feel bad now.
Why?
No, why? They're used to
why?
It.
Why? Because I'm cool. I'm cool and I take crap from nobody.
Look at them.
Yeah. That's right, baby. Uh-huh. Give me a high five.
There you go.
All right. Look at they're sponsored by Greenpeace.
Okay.
Look what happened last time I was here.
But seriously, what was it? What was it?
I was my
oh,
buddy.
When he was calling you a Martian?
Who? Oh, well.
Wait, who?
Oh, my.
Wait.
I just got my
Martian,
hair
I'm not
done.
A Martian no more.
The Marvin the Martian voice. Well, hey, yeah, no, well, thanks for watching, not Jamie Stewart. I know you're here for the monster and not for me, but I appreciate it anyway. And people were just mentioning Water Buffler, which, you know, how can you not? I definitely know that's a notable moment, again, patented, in one of the videos here. Which part was it? Must have been part 4. It's fucking shit. Water Buffler. and Zach from the Berg, he pointed out that whenever Dai said, yeah, I'll be there tomorrow. All right, I'm gonna check out Water Buffler real quick.
Hi, Charlie, how you doing?
Hey, I just want to congratulate you on your baby. That's great. Is the father a water buffalo or an elephant?
The father is a water buffalo.
Great. Is the father?
Yeah, I got it all wrong.
Charlie.
The father's a water buffalo. All right, so we're gonna do it like kind of like they did on the show because I'm very unoriginal. We're just gonna do Lady Nyan and Water Buffalo.
Did all that already?
Water
Why?
Buffler.
Why?
Here we go.
I wanted to congratulate.
But you did all that already. Why? Why do this?
Oh my God!
What was that?
Yeah. Hold on. Do we have that? Can we hear this again?
Yes, you can, Jimmy. Yes, you. Yeah, you can. I have it queued up.
You
You're very
did
welcome.
All that already. Why? Why do this?
Oh my God!
Okay, there's Lady Nyeh.
Congratulate you on your baby. That's great. Is the father a water buffalo or an elephant?
The father is a water buffalo.
Water buffalo. Here's Lady Nyeh.
You did all that already. Why? Why do this?
Oh my God!
I wanted to congratulate Lady Nyeh.
Okay. All right. All right. All right. Let's get back. Let's go back here. and then when Bobo called in as a fugitive and on the phone he broke character. It's like, nah, I'm the fugitive, and oh, sorry. And he's like, oh no, a dog walking in front. Oh no, a dog walked in front of me.
Neither is she.
Who are you asking about?
Mark.
Psycho Mark.
How's he doing?
Hey, how's the cancer? Did your uterus fall out yet, you dopey bitch?
Hi! Hi!
You Martian, you friggin' Martian mental case soap.
Thank you!
You think you had a life? You just walk in there? You
thank you!
Cancerous mental case.
I'm a mental case, I know, thanks.
Die, get in the coffin.
Die, get in the coffin.
I wish I was down there to berate you in person.
Come back, come up, say hi. I miss you.
She's inviting people to your show. Come on.
All right. Well, how did HBO miss this on the Bellevue special?
Okay. All right. With the Siri reference. Now I'm just thinking. Okay, Bobo, turn the lights on.
Okay, I'm gonna turn the lights on for you. All right. I'm not lying. I'm gonna turn the lights.
Bobo, shut the fuck up, please. Okay, Bobo, shut the fuck up. Turn the lights on.
Yeah, I'm gonna turn the lights on, okay? But I just wanted to say, I just wanted to call in. I love this show. It's for the show and the lights.
Special. Yeah, could have just taken the cameras right up here.
Guys, we gotta make a comment.
All right, guys, I just wanted to say hi real fast. It's probably my last time on NEW, but who cares?
All right, what do you want your final words to be on this show?
What time do you want me to show up for work tomorrow?
I mean, Ed, I gotta agree with you. We're definitely an odd group. I'll say that for sure. Anybody who spends their free time watching this shit is definitely an odd person. But we're all odd together, you know. That's cool.
I just want to call in. I don't want about the road trip. Call in. I have an idea for the road trip.
Hi, Mark. Lady Di, I notice you have a Lady Di shirt.
Yes, I have three
now,
of them.
Now, where did you get this? And it's got the big L like Laverne used.
No, I'm not dead, all right. I'm still alive. They're lying. I'm not dead, all right. It's for the show.
To where?
A friend of mine.
Because you're the retarded Laverne and Shirley.
I wanted to get one made up, but I said no.
Didn't you get that at Get a Life and Things?
No.
Kate Brennan, do you know his channel name? I'd love to just check it out. Not to fuck with him or anything. I'd just like to check it out.
Friend of mine.
All right. Shlemiel. Shlemazel. Yes, I got in a fight with a hair crimper.
It's funny. Eastside Dave from Ron and Fez. He's also doing doing a YouTube streamer, does a YouTube stream, you know, currently active on it. It's pretty cool. Bobo and Eastside Dave, that's what we need. There you go, David and Bobo. Eastside Dave and Bobo. David and Bobo with me, Stalker Patty.
I bought your tape, by the way.
Doesn't Diane looks like she's losing too? Doesn't she look like she's
losing? Sure, why not?
She's down to parachute.
She lost a little bit.
All right. Well, let Jeffrey Ross say something.
All right.
Cool. So at Daniel Curlin 182. Awesome, man. Thank you. I appreciate that. I'm going to. Well, you know what? I know it's only a handful of us here. But don't fuck with him. Bobo's cool, man. He got fucked too much. Having said that, okay, disclaimer over. Let's check out his channel. What are you doing, Bobo?
What kind of videos have you been uploading, Bobo?
Wow, MetLife still just kind of doing his thing. Look at that.
What's up, fans of Best Eaten House Podcast?
Yeah, what's up, fans? Oh, man, I love this guy.
As you know, I attended the NHL Stadium Series Rangers versus Islanders on February 18th, 2024.
Oh man, no! I'm in the mood to laugh at someone. We're not gonna watch that. I like that too much. I like him. We're gonna.
I bought your tape.
Monsters.
We are fine. No, you're
her tape, Jeffrey.
No.
I bought your tape. Cow's gone wild.
I don't look like a cow. You look like you need to lose too. Look at.
Hey, I thought you liked Jeffrey Ross. What happened?
Come on, Sybil, make up your mind.
I thought you liked the.
I could be more like The Exorcist.
Yeah. You can.
I bought your tape.
She can.
I bought your other tape.
I can make those exorcist. I can make those exorcist noises.
Jeffrey, what other tape did you buy?
Blubbers, bloopers.
Well, you haven't seen the exorcist. I could pop. I don't like pea soup. But
you make Rich Voss sound like Sir Anthony Hopkins.
You ever see Psycho? I could be a psycho.
Oh, Finster.
She could be a psycho.
Could be a psycho.
Yeah? All right. Very good.
Well, I guess you already know that.
Hey,
well,
all right.
Know
all right.
Me.
Back
I'll
under the bridge.
The
back,
make back, it look like an accident.
Back under the bridge. All right. Back under the bridge.
Yeah.
Ladies.
When Dime the Dude, when Lady dies, asking Bell Knox all those financial questions. how much do you make doing a porn scene? How are you? How much do you make?
There they.
Oh my God!
Lady
Di, White Castle closed today.
Always a pleasure.
We had to come up to say goodbye.
Of course you did.
Back to White Castle.
Yeah, I got the runs again. It's bad.
I don't know if you know. I don't eat White Castles. I'm into salad. I don't
Come
like White
on.
Castle.
You
I
smell like White
veggie.
Castle.
You smell like White Castle.
Do they make hair?
No.
You smell like you just crapped in your pants.
Oh, my God.
Hey, he's a friend. Hey.
He smell like White Castle. I don't like White Castle.
No, he's a friend. What's up with that?
I don't eat White Castle.
Did you hurt my feelings?
I don't.
That's great.
The tall one.
White Castle?
The tall one doesn't seem as retarded as the little one.
I like I'm in Tanella.
Hey, next time you come here, wear
fruit.
Your helmet.
Why? Next time.
You know what you'd be good for if they had like a
Yeah, I threw up in the sink because the toilet is just for number one and number two. So I took my clothes off in a public bathroom and I threw up in the sink.
Something.
Wait, hold on. Does
she look like Macy Gray after she looked in the Ark of the Covenant?
You're like Macy Gray's negative.
I don't know who Macy Gray is.
Oh, my gosh.
Game of Thrones is what channel is that on? Is that on? Bill, do we have HBO?
It's like Carmella Soprano.
Can I say something?
She looks like Paul Williams with breasts.
Holy cow. All right, time.
Paul Williams joke.
Wow.
Yo.
Paul Williams always looks like he had a bow on his head, and his hair got cut around a bow.
And that was after the accident.
But my hair don't look like I got a bow
on
it.
Good.
You got a red shirt. You heading down to gay Disney?
No, I'm not going to gay Disney.
I was trying to do it like a Chip voice, but it was the Bobo voice. But yeah, no, I was going to make a Chip joke right there. Good one, Marion. I got to work on the Chip voice.
I'm wondering, because Gay Marco called and said they wear red shirts. I thought maybe you had a thematic thing.
I wear what I want to wear.
Marion, can I ask you for a favor?
Sure.
One last wow.
No.
Yeah, that'd be great.
No.
Wow, usually everyone cheers. What happened?
But your new body.
The new body.
I said, I'll come up here in my bathing suit when I lose like 20 pounds by July.
It's the new Jan Brady. My boyfriend's George Glass.
Well, you guys are going to be at Asbury Park, right? That's what the rumor was going around in Jersey.
Hey, start swimming. Marion, for me? One last time.
No.
One last
I could go over and give you a hug.
No,
I won't do that.
The hug thing just doesn't work anymore.
No one wants to hug you.
That's okay. We'll be back. Don't worry about it.
Yeah, where? Where? Over here?
I'll say anything at this point.
Can I ask you guys something? Like, tomorrow or Monday, do we have to flip around the dials and find out where you guys are or what?
We'll call you at the Port Authority.
We don't hang at the Port Authority.
No, you live there.
We don't live at the Port Authority.
All right, listen.
Hey. Rich.
What's that? That would be Mr. Voss.
Do you own your own home?
No.
Well, I do.
Okay.
So. Oh,
that's good.
Congratulations.
And how far is it up to tree?
I don't
know. That would be good.
At least you get a hair with a waffle on here.
At least I make enough money to have my own home.
All right, listen.
It's a trick for everybody.
Well, all right, ladies.
What do you do?
None of your business.
Oh.
Look at you.
Marion.
None of your business.
Marion, one last wow. Quick.
No.
Please.
What
Please. At least the bunt.
No.
Can we see the bunt?
No.
The bunt.
No way. You do that.
Marion.
I won't do it either.
Marion,
no.
You did it before.
Well, no.
Marion.
Yeah, who mentioned Dye's Bubs? If you haven't seen those, check out the community tab. It's a post. And I hope... I mean, I guess if my channel hasn't gotten taken down so far, I guess this won't do it. But this is as close as you can safely get to seeing Dye's Bubs without actually seeing them. Behold. Look at her. Look at Lady Di. Look how happy she is, man. Look how much fun she's having. Look at that. She's just a spring chicken, having the time of her life, you know, a young, sexy chick, just riding out early age, or whatever, you know what I mean? Just enjoying the life of a young princess, Diana, or Banny. Look at that. Look at it. Here. We're going to zoom in. We're not going to zoom in on the attractive bodies there. We're going to zoom in on Di. Look at this. Look at her. Look how happy she is, man. I wonder what her kid was doing at this point. Right? Think about that. What was her kid doing when she was giving us this? Well, at least she was happy at the time. All right.
Mary Kay called. They're going to give you their money back.
No, I don't wear Mary Kay products.
I do.
She does.
I
know.
You're kind of normal. The tall one's kind of normal, though.
Well, thank you very much.
I'm sorry, okay? I had to show the pictures for the show, okay? I'm just trying to make a good show. It's for the show.
Pretty much. No, he's saying I'm normal, so I'm going to leave it that way. You keep talking.
Lady Di, do you cut your own bangs, though? What's up with that?
No. I had my hair done a few weeks ago, and it's growing out right now.
Yeah, it looks like you cut your own bangs.
Friends, Romans, and countrymen.
No. Exactly.
You got the alfalfa Schweitzer bangs.
All right, listen.
She looks like Friar Tuck.
Anthony Opie, we were listening to the show.
All right, listen, I'm getting a headache. Calm down, ladies. Just back up, because Monique's ready to perform. All right? We'll get to you in a minute. All right.
There they go, the retarded Laverne and Shirley going back out, outside into the lobby area.
All right.
That's good.
No, they can just sit in the corner.
All right. If you want to go in the corner, you could go in the corner. It doesn't matter. Back to the bridge.
You see her walk out with her little pocketbook?
Oh, my gosh.
Are they the funniest?
I love those two.
Funniest retarded people you've ever seen in your life?
I love them.
They should really do some sort of retarded sitcom.
Oh, well, I would watch that every day.
So Much Love. Starring the retarded Laverne and Shirley.
They can do a Broadway play, Two Abbots, No Costello.
You just see the yellow bus drive by in the intros while they're rolling the credits, and you see them with their hockey helmets on.
The next part is Marion comebacks. Get your notebooks out. Get your note apps ready on your phone. Write these down.
I'm drooling on the windows. I'd tune in every week.
Oh, we forgot to play their theme song. Sorry.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're fat. We're ugly. We won't shut up, and we're nauseating. We're so annoying.
Making sense for us is not possible. A warthog and Godzilla in leather pants. Yes, we're both retarded.
I got sort of a kind of line.
Yes, we were born that way. Yes, we're both
I got sort of a kind of a brain.
For the retarded Laverne Shirley. Hey, we got the retarded Laverne Shirley theme song.
Oh, here comes the theme song again. This never gets old.
Christ.
It's like we just listened to it.
Got a new perm
and lost 8 pounds. Though.
Yeah. Lost 8 pounds.
He's looking hot.
We'll let him in a second, but first the theme song.
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. We're ugly. We won't shut up and we're nauseating. We're so annoying, no one can take it. When we look in the mirror, we break it. We'll give you nightmares all day long. Like a couple of weeks, but an ounce of sex appeal. Making sense for us is not possible. A warthog and Godzilla in leather pants. Yes, we're both retarded, retarded.
Oh, that never gets old.
Philly, just
enjoy it, Jimmy. We'll be here when we get back.
This is Lady Di and Marion.
Hi. Hey, welcome back, guys.
Big fans, though. They are just fans of the show. and they come on every so often, and they hang out together, so we call them the retarded Laverne and Shirley. One of them actually works in a beer brewery, so it's like...
We're not retarded. No, we're not. Little nice. Little crazy,
we're not retarded.
We like to have
and
a lot of fun.
I'm not retarded.
Quick disclaimer, I gotta tell you. This is not an act. This isn't a debate.
For real.
These two are... Jim, you want to describe the retarded Laverne and Shirley for Philadelphia?
Go ahead, Jim.
Everyone in New York knows what they look like.
Go ahead, Jim.
Their hair looks like dryer lint. I don't know what that new hair do.
Hey, at least I look like Mr. Clean. Top job.
Oh. Oh, she's a...
Zinger!
She's a mullet,
no, mullet is what you're doing, Jim. Hair shame.
And they don't shut up.
That is an awful list. You know, you sound like Benicio del Toro having a stroke.
I know. It's Benico, I heard.
Whatever.
Not Benicio.
He's a guinea monkey. I don't care what his name is.
He's an actor. Okay. You gotta start watching TV more.
No, it's Benito, not Benicio. It's Benito.
We want to welcome you guys back, and we're glad that you've got three more, hopefully another 9 years.
Thank you.
Maybe another 9 years looking at us.
Oh, my God.
What? But, Philly, these guys...
Hey, what up, Dave? Thanks for joining, man. Thanks for watching.
They're very cool, and you'll get to know them. You'll love them.
I'm sold.
You'll love them.
I'm sold.
That's right.
It's really Marion.
Just listen to them for a week and forget. You guys will love them.
It's Marion. How
you'll be
you?
Addicted to them. I'm about 5'2".
It's rare that I meet a woman that I wouldn't even allow to lick my taint while I whack my bag. There's very few women I wouldn't allow just to tease the taint a little bit.
I heard they wanted to get together.
Okay.
Oh, Stinky's feeling her hair.
I like my hair. It looks good on me.
It looks nice
and
on her.
And nobody has to look at
Marion, the perm
day.
Is still, it's still tight.
It's, I like when it the way it's tight.
When is he going to listen
up?
I
like it.
Bill, what do you think of
I like it. And he knows
cool. Sounds good, Ed. Take it easy, man. No PayPal. I just do this for fun. I won't ever ask for money or anything like that, so no worries there. Just it's just cool that you were able to join. Take it easy.
I like it like this.
Cowbell Bill, what do you think?
If you don't like
the big yellow one's a son.
Harpo Marx, 6 months after he passed away.
No. I like it. Hey, at least my hair isn't gray. You look like you're getting gray hair.
That's salt and pepper, honey.
No, it's gray. It's a sign of aging.
Is that your natural hair color?
What?
Is that your natural hair color?
Yeah.
What?
No, it's not.
What?
Yes, it is. It's about, yeah, it is. Why?
Pull your pants down. Let's see.
It is.
Oh, my God.
Why?
If that's your natural hair color.
I have gray hair.
If that's your natural hair color, I'd be afraid to see what's in your pants. It would look like the cover of Phantom Comes Alive.
You're not going to know.
No, huh?
But Anthony, you look like you're losing
Thank
your hair,
you.
Too, like I said last Thursday. But it looks
yeah,
a
for
bit
sure,
more.
Ed. Take it easy, man.
A little
have a good
more,
one.
Well, it's you coming in
time.
Here every week. Maybe I get a
I
little
I don't come
receding.
In every week.
Hey, ladies.
Yeah, yes.
Why don't you explain the show to Philadelphia? It's
a wonderful show. It's a great show. They bust on everybody.
Marion's the killdozer and Black Earl's the faildozer. Get ready for the faildozer. Black Earl.
But they're great guys.
Right.
And you gotta have them. You gotta have them there. That's what it is.
That's all you got.
You gotta like go to Philadelphia.
Why don't you go in our place? Why don't you go? Why don't you go in our place?
To Philadelphia?
Well, we know about Philadelphia.
What?
I know about Pittsburgh and Scranton.
By the way, Lady Di has a crush on Anthony.
Oh. I sure do.
I'm still digging
much.
Marion, though.
What? Hey, Philly, give
Anthony.
These guys a week.
I like that. She's like a hard-boiled egg. I like it.
I don't like a hard-boiled egg.
I said you're tight like a hard-boiled egg.
I'm not tight.
Watch it, Anthony. You know I don't like that.
Oh, Jesus Christ.
And by the way,
from the linebacker,
Philadelphia, we're having a big contest. If anybody in Philly can keep an erection while these
better than you, it's. I know. I get it. I get it. I get the sentiment. But I mean, we're here for the retards, bro. We're here for the freaks and tards. That's what I'm all about. Freaks and tards.
Pigs are in the room. You win Aerosmith tickets.
We don't look like pigs. And Jim Norton, you're not that funny. You're corny. But let me tell you.
Oh, wait.
Corny? I thought Rich Voss was corny, but he's better than you are.
You're just saying that because you lisp like Voss.
No. I think I like Andrew Dice Clay.
You don't think Jim Norton is funny? Mary.
I don't look like a mullet.
I'd do you from behind, honey, so I could bury your face in the pillow, okay? You and your curly mullet.
Yeah.
You better start.
Hickory dickory dock. Marion should suck my... Oh!
That was terrible. Terrible dice voice. I was going to say something. I was going to reply to something someone said. Oh, yeah. No, Diamond the Dude. Just to make sure, if you're not doing it intentionally, I think you might be, like, behind on the stream. Maybe. I don't know. Just a heads up.
Respecting my man, Jim
Norton. Get out of here.
But respect this gangster. You and your aqua shirt and your skippies, you Kmart-looking bitch.
Hey, what do you look like?
Crazy.
You look like you've been
I'm a thug,
man. You look like you came from Penn Station.
Come on, Penn Station.
It looks like you came from Penn Station.
Wait.
You look like you're one of those people that are from Newark that walk down the street like, hey, I'm big and bad. Newark, New Jersey.
Nice hair.
Boom. Roasted.
Lower the blast shield,
Luke.
You look
like and somebody from, hey, look, I walk down the street, my crap don't stink. My,
this is Def Jam, Marion.
I'm cool. I'm hip. Yeah, you're hip, all right.
Hey, Marion.
What?
How many pounds have you lost?
About 9.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, where'd you find them?
Yeah. Oh, fuck. I was going to do Marion's voice, but it came out as Bobo. I'm not even going to continue with that.
I lost them, wait, too.
Where did I find them? Obviously, if you lost them, you found them again.
Oh, shut up,
Andrew. Honey.
No,
okay?
Hey.
I'm sorry. You can't say that on the air.
I lost them here, too.
I don't think you can say that on the air, but that was fun.
Huh? Lost nothing.
Where'd you lose the weight? We can't tell.
Yeah.
Your buns? You lost weight on your buns. That's a half belly, half, you know, bunt.
We look like you need to lose, too. Looks like the, some of the beer that you drink.
Every time you say something to Marion, she comes back with the same thing. Like, if you call her fat, she says you're fat.
You're fat. You're getting fat.
If she says you're fat, she comes back and says you're fat. No, you're fat. No, you're the fat one. Maybe next time you have the homeless shopping spree, you can have it in New Jersey, in Elizabeth, New Jersey. You guys don't know anything about the New Jersey malls, do yous? Yous. Scorch. I might have missed a couple of his earliest appearances, but I am definitely keeping time cuts of his appearances as I'm going through the shows. And obviously, don't get me wrong, I'm going to supplement whatever I do with clips that already exist. But yeah, I'm definitely considering Scorch. I've never even tried the Scorch voice. I'm not going to try it. He's a good character too. He's still doing live. I think, I don't know if it was brought up in chat earlier today or yesterday or something, but Scorch is still doing live streams. Still being Scorch. Still got the shitty setup. I don't understand it. I don't understand it because he still has, like, shitty audio. And at least the video I watched, the background was just, like, a fake brick wall with his name and logo. You know, kind of like the old school 90s spray paint look. Fucking Scorch, dude. He's just been chugging along this entire time. PFG TV. Scorch.
Anthony, you're getting a bear bite.
Marion, I weighed the same that I weighed when I got here.
Well, you look like you're getting a bear bite.
We could talk about whatever.
Hey, Lady Di.
Yes.
She's insulting your man.
I know she is.
Kick her ass for me. Kick her ass for me. Smack her in the head. Lady
Di,
smack that twat right in that friggin' head.
You don't want to see us in boxing ring, believe me.
No.
All right, well.
We don't do that. We don't do that.
Beat her with a strap on.
No, we don't. We've been friends too long. We've been friends since we were teenagers.
Oh, God, because no one else would hang out.
It was funny. I don't know if it was during Jocktober, but when O&A were roasting one of Scorch's shows, and he had that the guest on, that drummer guy. And he was dressed in, like, all black, and the couch that he was on was black. And, like, Norton made a joke, like, it just looks like a head, like, hovering there because the clothes blended in with the couch. I don't get Scorch, man. Like, he does...
No,
we fight for a couple of minutes.
And we have other people, but it's just that, you know, you join the service.
Wait. JoJo.
Hey, what's up, guys? Hello, boys. Congratulations, man. About time. Syndication on the pants.
Hey, thank you, JoJo.
Hey, we probably had a couple new recruits for the ONA Army until you put the two mongoloids on.
We don't look like mongoloids. We're not mongoloids.
Oh, we're not mongoloids.
Don't insult the mongoloids.
Look like a mongoloid. Your ass looks like a mongoloid.
Your ass looks like a mongoloid.
I'm tough. Don't look at me. I don't take crap from nobody.
I don't take crap from nobody. Yeah, dude, the Uncle Paul supercut, Dave, I think that was the first one I did, so obviously it's not, like, chronological or anything. I think I was saying it the other day when we were watching it. Uncle Paul is one of the funniest characters ever. Like, across movies, radio, whatever. Uncle Paul is hilarious and very disturbing.
All right, Max.
He doesn't. Yeah, he doesn't.
But, what's going on?
Hold on. That poor friggin' husband.
Baby Godzilla, man. Right? You look like
Baby Godzilla. Remember Baby Godzilla? She does.
If I had a picture, he would say something about that.
I may be short, but good things come in small packages.
Remember Baby Godzilla that blew the smoke rings?
I may be short.
Well, Mommy's calling. Marion.
And Godzilla in leather pants. Hammersley. How funny would that be? Full circle, right? Opie and Anthony reunite in person for the first time on Scorch PFG TV. Yeah, Naked Militia. Okay. All right, Naked Militia. Yeah, okay. Doucher dressing. Full circle.
All right, talk.
Time is a flat circle.
Talk into the microphone. Yes.
So don't come at me with pot shots. I come right back at you too with pot shots. You look like Godzilla.
You look like Cindy Brady. Ate too much of Alice's cooking.
Yeah, no. E-Rock sniffing her dirty panties, her dirty soiled panties that they paid over $100 for. I mean, it's bits like that that just makes the internship arguably the best part era period of Lady Di's saga or whatever. That's funny. Yeah, no, it was fucking funny. It's like, what did you say? It has like a time delay on the smell.
I have no idea.
She looks like Elmo started smoking crack.
It was like overbite. Mr. Flame.
That's where she lost the 8 pounds. The drool leaving her mouth.
Like Mr. Flame.
Hair's pulled so tight she can no longer close her mouth.
Who is this guy?
That's my Tina Cole.
Tina Cole.
All right. Jesus Christ.
You're like you got less hair
this
than him.
Disaster.
You're the one with the top job.
Could you put your Down syndrome mouth closer to the microphone?
Down syndrome mouth. Yeah, Voss's ear goop is disgusting.
Phone, please. She does look like Baby Godzilla. I'd like to see.
You got less hair than him.
Disaster.
You're the one with the top job.
Could you put your Down syndrome mouth closer to the microphone, please? She does look like Baby Godzilla. I'd like to see her and Black Girl fighting in a movie. I think.
I hear talk. You're not saying nothing. Talk.
Oh, God.
I am talking.
I can't take it anymore.
You are doing all the talking.
You talk.
I can't take that anymore. All right. Why don't we get the return?
Oh, that's cool, Jimmy. I'm glad. Glad you guys are liking it. It's really cool. But E-Rock, dude. E-Rock's a trooper, man. He was a fucking trooper. Remember the bit where they called him when he was on vacation and they just did whale noises for an hour? E-Rock's a fucking trooper, dude.
Throw Laverne Shirley out of the studio.
It was nice having
ejected.
You guys, we'll be back.
Jesus Christ.
All right, there we go.
Good God.
Okay.
Please.
Cliff, right back.
All right.
They're great.
Take care.
Imagine having to live with that.
Shut up.
Wait, you can't say that. Someone just called her a fat C word. You can't use that C word on the air, but sure, we all got it. What an annoying couple of, can I call them women?
Yeah, they're women.
And no, that Marion's getting all rambunctious now. Like, she thinks she's got the comeback. She called her fat. She says you're fat.
Call me corny.
Goof on her hair, she goofs on your hair.
and then when Jimmy starts doing the Jamaican accent, talking about the ice cream bowls, the empty ice cream bowls piling up to the ceiling, he couldn't open the door. Oh, my God. That was a great bit. That was great.
Corny. I think one of the girls hanged something yellow on the console.
What is that?
I don't know.
Holy smoke! Look at what's on the console.
Yeah, Bobby's probably on that Ozempic right now. Isn't that all the rage nowadays? You just kind of like jab some shit into your leg and you lose weight. Ozempic.
What is it? Don't touch it. Now, don't even look at it. Don't touch it.
What is it?
It looks like phlegm.
It's yellow.
Dude, she packed phlegm all over the console. Look, it's burning through like alien acid blood. Now she's lost 8.5 pounds. The hull has been compromised.
Smells like White Castle.
Hey, you can't dust for vomit. Don't talk about my husband.
We got to get her back in here.
He's got enough problems with being married to me.
Hey, we have an annoying laugh, Anthony, on the phone. Yes. Gazuki, baby Godzilla.
Baby Godzilla.
Hey.
See you later.
All right, later. How much do you have to drink on the O&A drinking game if Limo Anthony does an impression? You got to boot heroin. Whew. We have to take a quick break. Thank God. Who's going outside? Not me. Not me.
Dude, she is still really pissed off.
She's steaming.
Well, open the door. Let's see how pissed she still is.
Man, don't make fun of my husband. Don't talk about my husband.
Get ready.
Don't talk about my husband.
I'd say cage match, Jim Norton and Marion.
Marion?
That's right.
All right, hold on. Marion.
Signed up. It could bring a few quick bits on the open market.
Hey, here, you want to wrestle?
I would. Marion.
If wrestling doesn't require touching, we can do it, yes.
Marion, we've talked about your husband before. Why all of a sudden this defensive posture?
I don't like it.
What happened now?
Nothing.
Your husband's starting to give you a little crap about being on the show.
No, he listens to the show, but I just don't like that idea. Bring in my husband. I told my husband, don't know you. He listens to the show. He's never met him.
We've talked to him on the phone. I think we sparked up a great relationship.
And these guys did, but when it comes to something like that, I don't like it, okay?
What did you hack up on the console? Look at that. Look at what you hacked up.
What?
Right there.
You hacked up a friggin' tribble. I don't know what that is.
It did not.
That came out of your
crawl. It did not. It didn't come out of nothing.
Someone in a rocking chair once.
Anthony, I would appreciate it. Don't talk about my husband, okay?
Wow, look at that look she's giving you.
Really?
Ooh, she means it too, man. She means it.
You go in the cage. Goes in the wall.
Yeah, don't talk about my husband, Anthony. I mean it, okay? I'll charge at you like I do, like I charge at other animals on the Serengeti, because I'm a rhinoceros. So be careful, Anthony. Don't talk about my husband.
Yeah, no, we were saying earlier, man. Lady Di, she had a bright future. She had a bright future, but that alcohol, man, that'll get you. It'll get you. It'll get you.
Order.
Let's keep that up. Let's keep that one.
Marion's in the order. Our Marion.
Farewell. There you go. Let's keep that one up.
Spanish lady. Anthony?
Yeah.
I'm sorry, people got tempers. Boy, we
spit out that little Kittner boy all over the console.
Anthony?
What the hell is that?
Yes, Opie. She can't hear. I know. She can't hear us right now.
Yeah, why? People have tempers. They also have metabolisms.
Yeah.
I want
to get that set up.
Well, hold on.
What do you need, Opie?
Someone talk to Marion.
Yeah, you got to get it going again.
Look, you have like 10 guys between you and her. Let's talk about her husband again.
Marion, how much do you think your husband wants a nice, skinny, tanned ass as opposed to your ass?
My husband loves me the way I am, but I don't appreciate...
You think so? Absolutely not.
You talk about my husband.
He probably punches porno up on the website and jerks it every night to a hot, sweet little nymph ass.
I got something to say about my husband. I got something to say about your girlfriend, too.
Hey.
Well, I would rather not.
Hey,
Marion. I feel like it's not right.
Marion, I'm talking about your husband. But he's a nice guy.
He is a nice guy, but he's never met.
He's a nice guy. Does it look like that down below? That hairstyle?
It's not your business.
Or a little Wookiee?
Like, does that look like that
Wookiee
down below?
Yes.
Except,
hold on.
Do you shave your balls? Do you shave yourself down there?
No, no, I got one. All right, psycho Wookie down there. Psycho Mark.
Hey, guys.
Hey.
Put a bullet in both of their heads and just dump them in a river, will ya?
You? You want the job?
What's that?
You want
the job? Absolutely, I'll be right over.
Mark!
Hey,
I
heard your husband's got cancer in the bowels. Your husband has cancer in the bowels? That's too bad.
How you doing, Psycho Mark?
Okay, listen.
How's your husband? I heard he's been up in
toll. Yeah, better than you. I think talked about this. I don't know if it's today or whatever. But yeah, the three of them separate are unfunny. Even if it's two of them paired up, doesn't matter who the two are. Maybe Aunt and Jimmy. I think I said that. Maybe Aunt and Jimmy could be funny. But yeah, man, it was the trifecta. The show without any of them sucks. You know what I mean?
All right.
I don't like you.
All right, listen, we got to take a break. No one can understand my kid touch airways. We'll be back with the Opie and Anthony show.
All right, so we got Anthony's number one fan who was at the parade. She's been on the show before with her sidekick. I don't even know her sidekick's name. But yeah. It's the retarded Laverne Shirley.
Where else can my ball be, you stupid?
You gotta be nicer. I mean... look at him. I mean, come on. Are you ready, Ant? No. All right, let's bring him in. It's Lady Di, Anthony's number one fan, and...
Marion.
And Marion the sidekick, Anthony.
And Marion the sidekick. Yeah, it really was, or is... I guess still is the group dynamic. I mean, if they wanted to get back together tomorrow and squash their beef, you know, wipe the slate clean, as it were, they could, and they'd probably do well. But yeah, it's the group thing.
That's her name, Marion.
Marion. Marion.
How you doing, Anthony?
Hey, how are you?
Hi guys, how are you? All how's right. It going?
Go to parade today.
Good, good. What?
Did you guys go to parade today?
No, did you?
Yeah,
yes, we were.
Yes.
We were by Battery Park.
They just wanted to call in to congratulate Lady Nye.
As a matter of
fact, that's where the parade was.
Actually,
it would kind of be weird if you were uptown for the parade.
We were at the beginning of the parade.
You were at the beginning of the parade?
Yeah, beginning of the parade.
Why do I feel like I'm in special class talking to you? You're at the beginning? Good.
Yeah,
good.
At the beginning of the parade.
Yes.
You're at the beginning of the parade.
And what?
As a matter of fact, on one float, there was a wow sticker on there.
Are you kidding?
Picture of it.
Which
you
float?
Didn't do that. I didn't
do it. Oh, yeah. When her internship, man, it's just gold. Oh, by the way, she interrupts a conversation. By the way, I forgot to tell you guys something. Back in the 80s, my boyfriend gave it to me in the ass in a car every weekend. Like, what? Just out of nowhere. Dude, the internship. I think, goddamn, I think that's peak. I think that's peak Lady Di. Maybe peak O&A.
This time.
What float?
The one with Mariano Rivera on it.
Ah, see?
So
sure.
With the relief pictures on it, there was a wow sticker right there.
So what do you get to see at the beginning of the parade?
The floats. We got to see the floats and everything.
The buses came in and players were getting off the buses and stuff.
Yes,
the families, you know, Joe Torre.
And those are the buses, not the short yellow ones with the hockey helmets inside, right?
Yep.
Right.
Yeah,
right.
Those were the ones that brought them.
Right.
That was
a
great line by Jimmy. I didn't like
so
that.
So you're at the beginning
but
of the parade.
Andrew,
you
didn't either.
Everything. You were close.
Very close. We were down here since 8 o'clock this morning.
Since 8 this morning, you were waiting
actually,
for the parade.
Actually, 7:30. We were there.
Well,
since
we got
there
about 8.
7:30. You know? Let's say 7:38.
Yeah. 7:30, 8 o'clock. What's
around
the difference?
There somewhere.
Yeah. What is the difference?
Yeah, and, she's a Mets fan. She came with me.
I came with her.
You know.
Well, that's okay.
I'm not crying. That's all right.
And
it's always next year.
Ticker tape thrown on us and everything.
And you took pictures. You took pictures.
Yes, we did.
Yeah, we did.
Yes, we did. I tried to get a picture with the wow with the sticker.
Shut up, Demi.
Yeah.
On the float.
Uh-huh.
So if it comes out, we'll send them to you.
Thank you.
Okay.
A true fan of the show.
Yep. And my son is here too. If you want to let him in for a little bit.
Oh, that's right. You have a son. Does he drink?
Yes.
How old
this
is he?
This is when her son was
that's
in studio. 2001 was when her son was. Actually in studio. I don't know if you guys can hear that. Sorry, I'm heating up the nail. I'm going to take a bong rip. 2001. She brought her kid to the studio show. So he was still in her care in 2001. Does anyone remember when he actually got taken away? I can't remember that.
grandson.
Oh, that's Jim Cook.
How old is he?
Hello. Yeah, hey, Jim, how you doing?
Shut up, Debbie.
Yeah.
On the float.
Uh-huh.
So if it comes out, we'll send him to you.
Thank you.
Okay.
A true fan of the show.
Yeah. And my son is here, too, if you want to let him in for a little bit.
Oh, that's right. You have a son.
Does he drink?
Yes.
How old is he? No.
That's my godson.
Oh, that's Jim Cook. How old is he?
Hello. Yeah, hey, Jim, how you doing? He's 10 years old.
Sam Adams is good for 10-year-olds.
I love those impressions, Anthony.
Thank you.
That's Lady Di. She loves it.
Lady Di. I know. Hey. I'm flattered.
I know you're the Met fan.
Yeah, I'm
the Met fan. Were you at the game?
I'm moving on.
Yeah, it's it's pretty crazy how Peter was able to still become like a functional adult with this thing as his mother. You know what I mean?
I'm a Jet fan now.
Well, hey, I like the Jets too, and I also like Dallas.
Dallas, okay.
But I'm also a Ranger fan.
You guys want to go out on a double date?
I like the Raptors.
No,
there's no double dating, Opie.
Little double date?
No.
Why not?
There's no dating.
Lady Diane Ann, get the front seat.
We'll get the back seat. We'll
go to the drive-in movie.
We'll go to a drive-in.
Hold on. Let me drink a little beer. Hold on.
What's the matter? Oh, she's getting nervous.
She's getting nervous.
She gets nervous when she
She works for.
She's fine now.
She works for Budweiser.
Wait, what?
Drive-in. Hold on. Let me drink a little beer. Hold on.
What's the matter? Oh, she's.
Let me drink a little beer. Hold on. I'm here in studio. My son is here in studio. Hold on. Let me drink a little beer. Hold on.
Lady Diane Ann, get the front seat. We'll get the back seat. We'll go to the drive-in movie.
We'll go to a drive-in.
Hold on. Let me drink a little beer. Hold on.
What's the matter? Oh, she's getting nervous.
She's getting nervous.
She gets nervous when she works for.
She's fine now.
She works for Budweiser.
Yes, I do.
But she's drinking Sam Adams, so don't identify
her. She's on vacation.
Fire her ass. Okay.
Still on vacation.
Anthony, yes.
You have another fan that I want to mention
another,
to you.
Another? I do.
Who?
That's
one
more than me.
This girl, Luciana.
Yeah.
And all these people on the list here, Horny Goat Weed, Darth Precious, Stingray, Jay Moore Buddy, and Male Cyber Whore. They're all... You guys
big fans of
you know, we were on the show last week, right? And I went to work that Monday. Everybody heard us on the air. It was
fun. Oh, yeah?
They all listened to you. And people that I don't even know listen to you guys. I was
I have no idea who Dawson's Creek is. And, I think that's what you said, right? Part of your message is covered up by that stupid fucking emoji button. But that reminds me when Chris Rock was in studio. And, like, Lady Di is on the phone and she's on hold or whatever. And they bring her back after, like, a 10-minute talk with Chris Rock. And she's just like... Or she said, like, who's Chris Rock or something. I can't remember exactly. Fuck. That was funny, though.
Job.
How do they recognize you?
They heard my voice. They all know me.
You got a regular New York voice, though, right?
Yeah. Yeah, we sure do.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Hey, Lady Di.
Oh, Jim Creek. Wasn't Dawson's Creek referenced in the... by Di at some point? I'm pretty sure it was. Who's Chris? Yeah, okay, that's what it was. Yeah, I don't know who Jim Creaky is either, though. All right.
Di.
Yes.
What's your favorite Anthony impression?
My favorite one?
Yeah.
I would say the Ben Stein one.
Ah, that's a, yes, yes.
Ben Stein.
Never
I
even
like that
realized I could do that one until he was being a prick to us.
And by the way, we did not go to the Dice Show at Madison Square Garden.
Yeah,
we didn't bother getting tickets. But all that stuff, I saw you guys having a good time.
Like a ventriloquist.
All that stuff got downloaded in the beginning.
Yeah,
you know.
I am going to kick you.
Fuck, that's sorry. That was actually a pretty good little bit there. Okay, yeah, Jimmy. I'm surprised I didn't know that, considering going through the shows and they have him on regularly. They do. They always did Sam Adams shit back then. Yeah, that's who Jim Cook is. Wait, what? They collabed to get fired with? Wait, what? Anyway, yeah, so that's who that is.
That was
thanks,
a good show at the Beacon Theater.
Yeah, the
but
Beacon Theater.
But the only
Theater,
thing
yeah.
is, after
yeah.
the show,
yeah.
right?
Look,
we were hanging
on,
outside.
Over, look at this.
Lady Di showed her tits to Dave Chappelle. Dave Chappelle saw Lady Di's bubs. It's crazy.
They threw us out. They were like telling us all to go home. 11 o'clock, I'm ready to go home. What's wrong with these people? Don't they have, like, you know.
Hey, would you guys like to get on the lesbian couch today?
No.
Oh, and sorry, I keep pausing. I just wanted to say thanks, Alex. I appreciate it. Glad to have you here, man.
No.
Oh, usually there's cheers when I say that.
Just best friends. We ain't like that. Come on.
You've never had anything between you on one of those drunken nights, a little experimenting.
No.
Look, it. She's very adamant about this. No. I'm a married woman.
Yep.
You never.
Nope.
You didn't pet her poodle or anything.
No.
Okay.
No. Wait, right. Did you guys ever do anything together?
Well, there was a drunk night back in Boston.
Sure. Yes. Yeah.
And he asked me that, so I'm asking that.
Look! Is she smacking her for even asking? That's hysterical.
I know.
Why you?
That's not nice.
She's being reprimanded.
Hey,
Lady Di is reprimanding her.
Jim, what do you think of Laverne and Shirley? Here?
I do that.
Hey,
I think it's great.
Let's go. They're happy. They're drinking beer. Frickin' Frack. Which one's Frickin' Frack? Yeah, which one's Laverne and Shirley?
I could think of something else.
Frickin' Frack.
Frickin' Frack.
Because I'm a little taller.
All right, how do we get out of this, Sophie?
How do we get out of it?
Lady Di, would you like to hear Anthony do an impression for you? Live?
What?
Sure.
What do you want me to do? You're putting me on the spot.
But Lady Di,
you're putting me on the spot.
She's your big fan. Look at her.
Okay, do your dice impression.
Oh, I've done the dice. Too much. Not even me doing dice on the show is too much dice.
Wow, he didn't want to do dice at, what, 2001, 07, 07? Shit, what's my latest clip on that? Oh, okay. He was still doing dice or whatever in October of 2001, so still 3 months after this. Okay. I mean, yeah, I agree that that this show, it's not that it couldn't be done today, and I agree that the PC thing is partially the reason, but like a small partially. This show is lightning in a bottle. I mean, even at the time. You know what I mean? The only other comparable show was Ron and Fez, so it's not like this was just a common thing that anybody could do, and it's just the times that's not allowing. No, man, even back then, this was rare thing. And someone mentioned the naked bus thing. Yeah, my concha, the I think it was the teen voyeur bus is what did him in at first, but I can't remember exactly. But yeah, no. So yeah, I think the times maybe, or you know, you could blame the times a little bit, but I think for the most part, it's just it was just these three people. You know what I mean? It was just a combination of a shitload of things that ended up with these three people being together, and it just ended up being like the hottest shit, you know, for a while. So. That's all I think.
Oh, it's a garden show.
It was fantastic.
Did he sell out the garden?
Didn't you see it? You didn't go?
No, I was home watching the World Series.
Like everyone else.
Well, that was more important.
Gotta give her that one,
the week before.
Yeah, right?
All right, so Lady Di, what would you like Anthony to do?
Okay.
This is a special thing here.
Well,
very special.
Ben Stein.
Mm-hmm.
And you don't want to do dice again.
No dice.
Okay. Dice free.
All right, Jonathan Harris again.
Oh, dear. Spare me the poisonous barbs, Major West. Woo! Young William. There you go. See?
Look at her.
She's gushing.
She's turning her head.
She's
all right?
Smitten.
A couple of days ago, you did the robot.
Oh, she's fine.
Yes. I need my little thing here.
Here's the robot. Just for you, Lady Di. Listen to this.
Opie, I'm detecting danger in the studio.
See, there you go.
That's good. That is good.
Wonderful, huh?
Jim Cook,
I like that.
Pour some beers on my servos.
yeah, Darth, wait, who? Oh, Hammersley. Yeah, I think they definitely got fired for Sex for Sam 2, I think it was. Was it? See, that's the thing. I can't even remember. Like, I'm going through the shows, like, in this kind of period right now, the 2001 period, and I can't even keep it all together. yeah, they definitely got fired for Sex for Sam. I think they definitely got fired for the mayor's dead bit, too. I think they did, because they always bitched about that. God, that's one of the things about going through these shows, is they harp on and on about shit for so long. And I'm just, like, fucking trying to get through it. And I'm realizing that I'm kind of harping on right now and rambling. So.
There you go. Jim's speechless.
Yeah.
What's wrong, Jim?
Have you ever drinking. Been questions before for a living?
Jim's sitting there going,
last time you had a teen girl talking dirty. Now I get
it. We're past that stage.
Oh, y'all, get out of here.
What happened?
I had you pegged at like 19.
Yeah, you're right. How old do you think we are?
I don't know. I'd say you're probably 21.
Yeah.
I'd say. And you're like 25.
I'd say 45.
Yes, you're right. I'm 25.
25 and yes. 21.
No.
You're younger?
I'm younger.
Yeah?
20. You're in your 20s?
Nope.
Oh, all right. I'll take another guess.
No.
38 and 40.
Close.
You're close, but no.
Aunt,
what? Would you humor your pal with a... with
Opie, if you don't shut
30, 50,
your mother...
What? Aunt, would you...
What? No.
Would you humor your pal Opie with a...
I think, I can't remember if they were beefing with Dice at this exact time. What is this? 2007. Oh, yeah, of course, I didn't label any of the timestamps around that. Yeah, why would I label anything so that future me can reference it, easily reference it and know what it is? Why would you label anything? Yeah, so I can't remember when they actually started beefing with them.
With a prison visit from Lady Di, like you made me deal with Stalker Patty. Would you humor your old pal? Do you guys know what the prison visit's all about?
No.
You ever hear the prison visit?
I don't. Do you?
Remember that scene from Midnight Express, the movie where?
No, I don't know what a prison is. Rhinoceroses don't get imprisoned. They don't imprison animals. We get the roam free on the Serengeti. So why would I know what a prison is? No.
That guy was caught in Turkey.
I haven't seen that movie.
He was caught in Turkey with some hash. They arrested him, and he spent a lot of time in this prison and got all mental about being in there. And then his girlfriend came after a couple of years to see him, and he was all disheveled, and they were separated by glass. And she took out her boobs and smush them against the glass so he can see them through the glass.
What do you say, Lady Di?
Parts unknown. That's Trailer Park Life. you know how it is. That's Trailer Park Life.
Come on, you'll be a star. You flashed already. No cameras. You go on the other side of the glass, the thick glass.
No, that's right.
Well, there you go. No.
Hey, she's got her son out there.
Her son's out there.
He is.
Well, take him to the Disney store or something. We're doing a radio show here today.
You've seen him before. He was just a little younger.
Right.
He's a 10-year-old kid.
Next time.
I'll do that next time.
Next time? Next time. Next time,
will there be a next time?
You can't just have blueberries. You gotta have something else with them. Blueberries, they're standalone fruit.
Yes, there will.
Do you have another reason to stop into the city?
I'm surprised you guys are Yankee fans and Mets fans. You didn't go to a parade.
Rest in peace, Fezzy.
Very surprised.
We have a radio show to do.
Yeah, but that's before 2 o'clock. The parade started at 12.
I'm not celebrating with the Yankee fans.
Yeah, well, I do. Why not?
Because we have lives.
What? Oh, sorry, Jim. Jim just choked on his beer.
Well, if the Rangers win the cup, I got to go to a parade. Jim. Yeah, I wonder who knows when I'll go.
What? What? You want... What?
What?
All right.
She said she doesn't know when the Islanders are going to win the cup.
But I'm a Ranger fan.
Yeah, all right. George, what's up?
Sure. Hey, guys, how's it going?
All right.
I don't know what brought this to mind, but I just started contemplating Darwin's theory, survival of the fittest. Just wondering what the hell went wrong with that. Maybe you guys want to discuss that one.
Jim, I believe that's a question for you.
What happened with evolution? It brought us here.
Thank you, Jay. Our two fans having a lovely time here at WNEW.
What's wrong with this guy?
It's a big day for you guys, right?
Oh, yeah.
Yes, it is.
Very, but especially for her.
Yeah. Brian?
Yeah.
Hey, what's up?
I'm just wondering, are there like open sores and cigarette burns involved, like around mouths or anything?
Why would that happen?
I don't know. I'm getting a truck driver vibe. Like, you know, couldn't find the ashtray, so just put it out in the forearm.
Ryan, they're very lovely ladies.
Are they? I'm very tough. Thank you so much, believe me, you wouldn't want to mess with me.
I'm very tough.
Can Anthony do an impression of?
I'm very tough. I have a very thick hide. But nothing can penetrate my thick hide because I'm a rhinoceros. I'm very tough.
Of a psycho slashing two freaks' heads off. Well, an instant feedback.
My opinion is... That
very good. Play the silent game.
Really good.
See how long it takes them to get the point. That's a great idea. Are these two women aspiring lunch ladies?
I thought he was good. Yeah. I could gain weight. Yeah, everybody gains weight.
They didn't hear us. They didn't hear what you just said, so we'll do that.
Okay. Oh, here comes the camp.
Uh-oh. What do we do now? Hi.
I don't know.
Buddy.
Oh, boy.
You got an audience here.
Hi, guys.
Oh, God.
How you doing? Who are you? Wow.
I want a wow show, too.
What was it, Friday that Dice called in? He was on 57th Street or something? And you kept on saying he was on 57th and he got mad at you? That was funny.
Funny.
There was a thing in a post that he was at some store a block away.
Right.
He was here. They're going to put us on a website.
I think they are.
Hi.
They're going to put us on a website.
I don't know. Why is it so quiet? Anybody talking? Well, it's too quiet in this place. Talk. Why is it so quiet?
No.
Why is
it? Well, see, maybe it's silent.
I don't
know.
Why? Okay. Bye, guys.
Why is it so quiet?
Oh, my God.
You're horrible.
That is the best new game we've ever come up with. God, it gets so uncomfortable.
That's bad, man.
Oh, my God.
Why is it so quiet?
As they walk away, why is it?
Okay, bye, guys.
What is this? What is this, Jimmy, that you're referring to? The supercut, how it's going to be organized in the future? I don't know. I don't get it. Tomorrow is Di's birthday. Happy birthday, Di.
It is the most uncomfortable thing.
The whole time, Ann and I are just staring at them and smiling and nodding.
All right, that's Lady Di and her sidekick.
Yes. Dan from Hoboken. Marion. I think you guys have just found the new morning show, Dead Air with Lady Di and Marion.
Oh.
All right. One half of the retarded Laverne show.
Marion.
Hi, Opie. Hi, Anthony.
Hi, how
are you doing? Hey, me and Diane had a great time Saturday.
That was a lot of fun. Good.
Hey, Anthony.
Marion, your boobs rest on your hip.
I don't care what they do. Me and Diane did it for the fun of it. We had so much fun.
Well,
I don't care how they... Hey, when you're over 35, that's what happens. But we don't care.
Exactly.
We had a great time.
Well, God bless you.
When are you guys doing?
Anthony was looking at one of your pictures on stage and said that.
Well, because I was dancing, I thought I had a good time.
You just look retarded.
I don't care.
The picture, your face, you got your mouth wide open and you're like jumping around.
Anthony, I don't care. I had a great time.
Well,
I haven't
for
had
you.
That much fun, and I don't know how long, really.
Been a while, yeah.
Are any of these pictures, like, labeled so people know who's who?
I hope so.
We get those complaints all the time.
I don't. Well, I'll look later on to see the pictures, but me and Diane, we had a great time.
Marion has the tight blonde perm with the big goofy glasses. And
I had my hair back.
And her body looks like a turnip.
Turnip.
She looks like a Jewish rhinoceros.
I'm not Jewish. I'm Irish.
Someone said you look like the...
I had a great time.
What was that email I was reading to you today? She looked like the dwarf or the midget from Willow.
I don't care what
Willow?
I look like.
From Willow.
I don't care. I had a great time. Hey, you guys doing another road show in August somewhere or what?
We got a couple ideas we're throwing around.
Because that would be great to do another one on a Saturday somewhere else.
Yeah, wouldn't it?
I mean, hey, let me tell you, I couldn't believe the good time that we had, really.
All right.
It was great.
Thank you, Mary.
And we'll see you, me and Diane will see you guys soon.
Can't wait.
Hey, you know what? She'll be calling you guys.
Thank you. Holy mother of God.
We consider Brian Regan a friend, obviously, Anthony.
Oh, yeah.
And we'd like to share with Brian, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think he needs to. Have you ever met the retarded Laverne Shirley?
Oh, what are they doing here? Why are they here today? We just.
Yeah, that was Adrian. That was pretty good. That was a funny video that he took, the videos.
Teen girls in, the palate was cleansed. You're going to dirty it up. We just had a high colonic of teen girls, and now you're going to put some red meat back in our intestines.
I just wanted to call into the show and congratulate Lady Di.
Nice guy, man.
Hi.
Get away from me, you and that. What are you going to do about that perm, man? What did I told you about
I'm
that?
I'm getting a cut.
Nice meeting you, too.
Pleasure.
Hi, lady.
I heard so much about you.
Oh, my God. Look at Brian's heart.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Hi, Becky. How are you?
All right. Listen, though.
What's the matter?
What is that?
What do you have? You got bling bling. I think you're wearing what they call bling bling.
Lady Di's got some bling bling.
You got some bling bling. What is that, old dirty?
This is the beginning of when Ant makes the same joke about the bling bling being like tin or you know, aluminum foil. He must have made that joke at least like 4 or 5 times, like over the you know, the next couple weeks after this or whatever. Ugh.
That's tin. That ain't no bling bling.
Oh, there you go.
That's bling bling.
Tin. That ain't no bling
that's
bling.
Really, that's tin. The real
man,
thing.
My poodle got a ticket.
I saw that last Saturday. Opie did.
I was not looking anywhere near that little medallion.
We came in for another wet T-shirt contest, guys.
Yeah, why not?
You are like one of the homies with a lot of the gold chains around you. You're like Mrs. T.
Psycho Mark said I look like Mr. T.
Right.
Yeah, Mr.
or Mrs. T. Mister.
I pity the poor fools see me naked. Yo, them chains are so thin.
We had such a good time.
Oh, my
Yo,
God.
Last Saturday.
You don't talk over me.
I'll be
right?
quiet.
Oh, those chains Yo. Are so thin, not even a crackhead's going to rob you.
you got like
half a penny weight on around your neck. You got, come on, Mike. You're going to spend money on jewelry, Mike. You got to come see me.
And I spent some money on jewelry.
You got to melt that down. To make like a cap or something.
No.
What is that, yo?
All right, I gotta make it clear. That's
They're
not
changed.
Me saying this. That's old dirty.
Jewelry store?
Hey,
do you work in a jewelry store?
God. Are they a little thin? Is that what the problem is?
A little dirty.
Do you work in a jewelry store?
Brian, you need the real heavy gold.
You need a little,
Let's ask Brian, Anthony. Brian,
I think they look nice.
Thank you very
Brian's
much.
Brian's a nice guy.
Nice
man.
Little touch, you know? A little color.
Brian, where's the little
one? Says wow, one says wow, one says okay, terrific, and the other one says O and A.
Yeah. Wow. Hey, Brian, where's your bling bling?
I'm going to go get some right now. Now that I realize how good it looks. Got to go to the bling bling store. Right. Pick some up. Ladies, why are you here?
We figured we'd take a walk over here. We had nothing to do tonight. We figured we'd walk around Manhattan.
You're just walking around.
I need the exercise.
Oh, yeah, you do. Pushing that perm around.
Hey,
how you push that perm around in the wind?
I'm getting a haircut anyway next week.
Yeah, and then Adrian waves her off, and she's just like, okay, fine, help yourself. What the fuck was that?
Are you getting that cut off? What are you going to do?
No, I'm getting it trimmed again. I just got it trimmed
baldy.
3 weeks ago.
Now, what are you doing?
The perm's a little tight still.
No, it's
a little
not.
Tight.
Hey, it was okay last Saturday because I had it back.
Oh,
that's all right, isn't it? I didn't get a haircut.
Yeah, you got that dead hair. You got that dead hair like you're Jewish.
Hey, so can I ask you guys something?
It's all about Brian Regan right now.
I want to ask you guys something before I forget.
Yeah.
Because I forget a lot. Are you guys having another road show like the way you did last Saturday?
Oh, what do you think? What do you think?
I'm
this
only
is every
asking
week?
You.
Brian's
you
shocked.
Guys,
Brian's just
week.
Looking around like, what's
fun.
Happening?
Fun. I thought I would ask if you guys are going to do another one like last Saturday.
Yeah, you had a good time.
Who, me?
Where were you?
I was
oh, my God. Listen, the retarded Laverne and Shirley.
We just wanted to know.
Hey, Marion, it's not every day that Brian is in the studio.
No, no, go ahead. I don't mean to interrupt.
No,
you're not interrupting at all.
Nice to have you.
Shout out to some people.
It's a big tent.
Wait till you hear this.
Wait, no, I was thinking maybe you could, show.
That's why I carry KY around with me for moments like this.
Yes.
Oh, fuck.
Yeah. And we'd like to share with Brian, right?
Mm-hmm.
I think he needs to. Have you ever met the retarded Laverne and Shirley?
Oh, what are they doing here? Why are they here today?
Fuck, did I just...
We just had teen girls in. The palate was cleansed. You're going to dirty it up.
I don't know if it went back to the same spot.
We just had a high colonic of teen girls, and now you're going to put some red meat
back in
our
intestines. Let me know if I need to go back or forward. I can't remember.
Nice guy, man.
Get away from me, you and that. What are you going to do about that perm, man? What I told you about that?
I'm getting a cut.
Nice meeting you, too.
Oh, hi, lady.
But I heard so much about you.
Oh, my God. Look at Brian's horrified.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Nice to meet you.
Okay, we're like 30 seconds behind. All right, fuck it.
What's the matter?
What is that?
What do you have? You got bling bling. I think you're wearing what they call bling bling.
Lady Di's got some bling bling.
You got some bling bling. What is that, old dirty?
Yeah, that's tin. That ain't
actually more like a minute.
You're like Mrs. T. Oh my God.
Yo, last Saturday.
You don't talk over me.
Oh, big
right?
Oh yeah, I remember that. You don't talk over me.
You're gonna spend money on jewelry, man. You gotta come.
Jewelry store?
Hey, yeah, a jewelry store. You work at
a
jewelry store. Okay.
Is that what the problem is? Gotta go to the bling bling store. Fix them up.
Ladies, why are you here?
We figured we'd take a walk over here. We had nothing to do tonight. We figured we'd walk around Manhattan.
You're just walking around.
I need the exercise.
Oh, yeah, you do. Okay. Pushing that perm around.
Hey,
how you push that perm around in the wind?
I'm getting a haircut anyway next week.
Are you getting that cut off? What are you going to do?
No, I'm getting it trimmed again. I just got it trimmed 3 weeks ago.
Now, what are you doing?
The perm's a little tight still.
No, it's
a little
not.
Tight.
Hey, it was okay last Saturday because I had it back.
That's all right, isn't it? I didn't get a haircut.
Yeah, you got that dead hair.
You got that dead hair like you're Jewish.
Hey, so can I ask you guys something?
It's all about Brian Regan right now, Marion.
I want to ask you guys something before I forget.
Yeah.
Because I forget a lot. Are you guys having another road show like the way you did last Saturday?
Oh, what do you think? What do you think?
I'm
this
only
is every
asking
week?
You.
Brian's
you
shocked. Brian's just
week.
Looking around like,
a
what's
fun.
Happening?
Fun. I thought I would ask if you guys are going to do another one like last Saturday.
Why yeah, you had a good time. Who, me?
Where were you?
I was oh, my God. Listen, the retarded Laverne and Shirley.
We just wanted to know.
Hey, Marion, it's not every day that Brian is in the studio.
No, go ahead. I don't mean to interrupt.
No, you're not interrupting at all.
No, nice to have you.
Shout out to some people.
It's a big tent.
Wait till you hear this.
Wait, no, I was thinking maybe you could, show Brian the love and maybe, flash Brian.
Oh, no. You guys have an act that you do?
Oh, yeah.
No, this is what they do.
This is the act.
What else can we say?
This is the act.
Hey, Anthony, my act was dancing on stage with him last night.
Right.
Yeah, me too.
Yes, it
me
was.
Too.
It
I
was.
Had a good time.
You guys were dancing and you were topless as you were dancing.
Oh, my.
Hey, Marion, would you mind flashing Brian? Because he wasn't at the road show.
What is it? Is it bling bling or bling bling?
I didn't blink at the road.
Oh yeah. What's up with your hair? Do you work at a salon? Do you work at a hair salon? What's up with your hair?
Until your eyes are closed.
Bling bling.
You were flashing.
Hey, lady. We saw it. Lady Di? Lady Di?
Yes.
Would you do the flash for Brian, please? No, there's no cameras or anything.
No cameras?
No.
Promise. Brian would love to see your.
This isn't happening.
Yes, it is.
Oh. This isn't happening. That's what you say, like right before you're being tortured.
People,
this isn't happening. It isn't happening.
That's hot, right, Brian?
Hot.
Yeah, you know.
Oh, Brian.
You're proud of yourself. That's cool.
Right. Self-esteem. What does Lady Di want to say? Because we got to get Brian out of here.
Can I give
minutes.
A shout-out to some people? The Station House Bar in Elizabeth, New Jersey. Everybody says hi.
Elizabeth? Isn't that like what he got? All
the Station House Bar? Is that what it was?
What does Lady Di want to say? Because we got to get Brian out of here.
Can
in
I
a few
give
minutes.
A shout-out to some people? The Station House Bar in Elizabeth, New Jersey. Everybody says hi.
Elizabeth? Isn't that like what he got? All the containers and all the ships driving sailors and all that? It's kind of grimy out there.
Grimy.
So I'm thinking maybe in like another hour on the stream or something. Maybe shut it down at whatever clip ends closest around 3.5 hours. We're at 2.5 right now. So yeah.
But we don't live in Elizabeth Port.
Yeah, don't be touching the mic. You and your lisping and your.
That's okay. My lisp is fine.
Mm-hmm.
I got the lisp because I didn't want braces when I was younger.
Is that what happened?
No,
my lisp is fine. Is that what happened, Mary?
Yeah.
You didn't want braces. Is that why you have that whistle?
Yeah.
Why not?
I didn't want them.
Braces are fine.
I had braces, bud.
Yeah,
this is their act, Brian. Yeah. Don't you love it?
It's a good act. Do you need an opening act, Brian? It's a good act.
That's all. Yin and Yang.
Yeah. So hey, you know what? They used to call us that when we were in our 20s. Yin and Yang.
Yin and Yang.
When
I
was in our 30s, we got called other stuff.
They used to call us that in high school.
30s.
We got to bring back the old team.
Yin and Yang.
What's our saying?
Yin and
Yang.
Party.
Party.
Yin and Yang. Party.
That's it. What a way to start off the Friday.
Yin Yang Party.
Of course.
Okay, you missed it last Saturday. You would have had a good time.
Hey, you were bumping donuts with the other one.
I was having a good time.
You two were in the lesbian pool.
I had a great time. And you know what? I haven't had that much fun. I don't know how long.
Really?
Yeah. I'm serious.
And your husband wasn't with you.
Hey, let me tell you one thing. My husband took all the pictures, and he told me as long as you had a good time.
Really?
He picked us up at the train station, took her home.
And how about that? All right. Tony, what's going on?
How you doing, guys?
Good.
Good. Hey, I'm going to get my wisdom teeth pulled next week, and I was wondering if Brian Regan could kind of help me out with that.
I'd feel awkward getting into that when we got Yin and Yang here.
You're all kind of... nicknames were
the only
party girls.
I got last week was this.
What?
Who punched you?
Wait, what? You're party girls now? What happened?
We've always been party girls. Why?
Oh my God, she has a cassette tape. Who has cassette tapes?
She has a cassette tape of Brian Regan's great CD.
I'll sign your A-track. Lady Di, what are you doing with cassettes still?
What am I doing with a cassette player?
Lady Di, like L.A.
DVD, CD players are like dirt cheap now.
Oh, yeah.
Hey, Brian, where are you playing at?
OD, how much for a CD player now? How much?
You want one for the hoop? It's 50, 45, 50 bucks.
45, 50 bucks for a CD player.
I also have a CD. I would like for you guys to listen to one of these days.
What is that?
Sure. Okay.
What is it?
I'll
break it, Opie.
No, Opie ain't going to break that.
Let me see. You got it from someone.
What is it?
It's a CD, Evelyn Forever. What is it, CD
Evelyn? What is it? What's the title of that?
It's called Evelyn Forever.
What is this?
It's Evelyn.
What is this?
It's a rock and roll CD.
From who?
From who?
From a band. I believe they're from South Jersey.
And you know them?
Is that their name? Evelyn Forever?
I know one of the producers, Joel.
So. Oh, I see what you're trying to do.
Slipping a plug in.
Opie, maybe.
He's a friend of mine.
Well, we've gotten CDs in the past, and my God. It's in the CD player. Opie just put it in the CD player. Brian's horrible.
Put it on the CD.
Oh, my God. Brian's
I have another one at home.
Opie, can you guys just listen
don't
to
come
him
over
before
here.
You broke it?
Oh, my God. Opie filed it.
It's fine.
You put it in an appropriate place.
What happened there,
Opie?
Going
to listen to it later.
What is this, Smash CD Friday or what?
Did that slip out of your fingers?
Brian's the nicest guy in the world. He can't believe when you hung up on that guy, that was bad enough. But
hey, I'm glad I don't have my Soprano CD on me. It probably smashed that on me, too.
Oh, my God.
I got a Soprano.
Now I have to go get another one now.
That one's shattered.
Soprano was wrong.
That's cheap quality. What's wrong with that
thing?
What's wrong with that thing?
Just set it on the stack over there.
It exploded.
I'm sorry, Joe.
That's how whack it was. That's how whack it was. Yo, beat is explode when you set it down. It's like nacho glycerin or something.
I thought you were... a nicer one.
Oh my God. Oh,
yes.
Yeah,
yeah. Good thing you didn't hand it to
me. Are you having a bad day today?
No.
Brian, he smashes everything.
Oh, I know.
Brian's one of my favorite comedians, and he hasn't even been able to talk for last night.
That's fine.
I'm waiting for him to say something.
I would like to get a copy of that, though.
Lady Di, you have a shirt now. She has a shirt now that says Lady Di, and the L in it is exactly like Laverne's L from Laverne and Shirley.
That's perfect, isn't it?
Yeah.
I have three of them.
Oh, and then Marion's got a cute little flower number on there with matching shorts. Where'd you pick that up?
With the white stockings.
Thank you.
I have nice clothes.
Hey, Marion, I got to tell you something, and this is the God's honest truth. I have a great aunt in Astoria. She has the same top.
Where'd she get it from?
She's 96 years old. Okay. Swear to God.
Shut up, Obi.
What? That's a style now.
I'm just saying, you know.
That's a style. Yeah, the Schinkel character is funny. That might be one of the only funny things of the Opium Gym show. Schinkel about it.
Is that the style now, OD?
These two are living back in the 50s, dude.
Flowers,
man. They never go out of style.
And Spencer's lobbing stuff at Marion.
He's doing tic-tacs.
Flower children.
It almost looks like a pot leaf, Marion.
If you had a little marijuana leaf print on that shirt, I could understand that.
Where is Steve today?
Hey, ladies.
On vacation, I guess, right?
Oh, my God. They just babble. Worse than Anthony. Limo Anthony.
Ladies, Brian Regan's getting very annoyed.
No, I'm not. Hey, Opie, how is this guy going to talk? I'm waiting for him to say something.
Look how much you're pissing off Brian Regan, man.
Brian's never been so furious.
No, it's good having you guys here. We're all hanging out, doing our thing. I'm here.
You want to wait here?
Ying and yang.
Ying and yang party.
You know everything about him.
We're all talking, having fun. Brian was on Letterman recently.
Yeah.
I'm sure Letterman gave him a little more respect than this.
No, it's great.
Hey, let me tell you guys. You guys had a lot of fun last Saturday, especially with us.
Oh, my God. We know. We talked about it for 2 days.
You kept telling us to have fun.
All right, Marion.
I was?
Marion, you got to show Brian your boobs?
No.
Why?
Marion, those are the ones you got to see.
I saw.
Like, you saw Lady Di, but Marion's are the ones, man. Those are guns, man.
Yeah, we have no cameras on.
Marion's the hot one.
You did it the road.
Wow, look at that. You see that bra? Did you see that white bra she's wearing? That's hot.
That's fashionable, too.
Yeah. That's hot. No, Marion's hotter. She's got those big guns, man. She got the huge guns. I like that.
I heard the big toe.
All right, listen, ladies. This has been wonderful.
Yeah.
Okay.
So, yeah, can you leave so we can talk to Brian?
Sure.
No.
Diane liked me so much.
I'm waiting for Brian to just snap. All right, yeah, leave.
Oh, you don't want us to leave, Anthony. You had a good time. Hey, when are we going dancing on stage again? Come on, let's go.
What the hell? What did you do to these two?
Hey,
all I know is my band was playing. We're on stage. These two come up and start dancing and taking their tops off on stage. And I was just horrified. I couldn't continue.
Hey, Paul, what's up?
Fine.
Hey, I want to say one thing, man.
Yeah.
Brian.
Yes.
The big stupid one is Lady Di.
Look at that tie-in. Brings it right back together, huh?
Something over now, man.
From my act. Right. Why don't you guys? You want to dance with Brian or something?
No. I
would love it.
Play some music.
I gotta go.
I'm into dancing, so.
All right, listen.
Great.
We gotta get Brian
and
out of
the nerds
here.
I knew from when I had my house down the shore.
Oh my God.
Okay, listen.
They just babble.
We
don't babble.
Is that what are those pictures of?
That ain't me.
Is that you guys in the lesbian pool? Oh my God!
Look at Lady. Oh,
that is. Hey, that.
It's a little publicity photo.
That ain't me.
Let me see that one, Brian.
I think it's the same one.
Oh, it is the same shot because you need two. Wow, look at that.
That ain't me.
Oh, my. What is that smell? What are you. Yo, which one of you broke wings?
Not me.
Yeah, you got nervous and I saw your fluttering shorts.
I don't have fluttering shorts.
Did you guys fart?
I wish.
Oh, my God.
Holy.
I got to go.
Holy.
Oh, no.
Hey, LJ.
Hey, Brian, what do you think of that
fart? Who did that, man?
I'd like to see anyone come out to Bananas.
Who did that? Confess up. Marion. Did you fart, Marion?
No.
Brian, snap. Snap right now, Brian.
Holy.
Brian's in the blast zone and he's still being polite. You're unbelievable.
You're at ground zero.
Right.
I was about to say something.
And you said it right out your butt.
No, I didn't say it right out my butt.
You farted, Marion. Hey, Lady Di did then.
Hey, Brian, you don't mind a fart every once in a while, right?
No, you know, sometimes people have to do their thing.
Sure, because I didn't do anything.
Want me to take a lie detector? I didn't do it.
That was rough.
Ladies, it's not the time, you know, that time of the month, is it?
No. That's over with. That was last week.
Oh, I thought that was over with for good. I thought that's what you were saying. No, I thought that's
That don't happen.
I thought that's what you were saying.
No.
Holy ass, that stinks. Really?
It still stinks in here. Jesus Christ.
Continuing.
What are you doing? Ben, stop it. Ben, spray him down. Spray him down.
Come on.
Spray him down. Spray him down with the pledge. All we can find was Lemon Pledge. That'll work. Where does she gotta go, please? Ladies, come on.
Yes.
Stop with the farting.
I got somewhere to go.
It smells like somebody ran over a skunk.
Where do you have to go, Marion? That's so important.
Us.
All right, listen. Where do you have to go? That's so important.
You guys, we're going to play your theme song. That means it's the end of your segment.
Right. All right? And you get to go.
If you want.
Huh?
Oh, it still stinks in here.
Ladies, leave.
It's not even diffusing or anything.
This isn't even a joke anymore. Leave.
Goodbye. Retarded Laverne and Shirley, thank you for coming by with your bling bling and your perms and everything else.
And here's their theme song. It's quick.
It's
1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. What's that? We're ugly. We won't shut up and we're nauseating.
There you go, the retarded Laverne Shirley. Yeah.
All right.
Thank you. Get some Rick's lighting matches in the studio.
Oh, yeah, Lady Di was insanely jealous. When she calls in, hey, can you need change the caption on the website? It was Lady Di that gets covered in beer. Hey, I'm Lady Di. It was Lady Di that gets covered in beer.
That was one of the worst, dude. Most potent, most long-lasting farts that has ever happened in this studio, right. And it was one of the retarded Laverne and Shirley.
That wasn't you, Brian, right?
No, it wasn't. Okay. Nice. That was one of the retarded Laverne and Shirley. They let out a big gas bag. Oh, my God, was that awful.
Well, it was interesting.
So what did you think of them,
say that.
Brian?
You know, I know they come out and watch your guys' thing.
Fry's a nice guy.
He's a diplomat, man.
You know what I'm saying?
How amazing is this guy? He has nothing bad to say about anyone.
Are they still... Just open the door for a second.
Dude, they are laying on the couch, high-fiving each other.
They think they're so great.
Because of they heard you say yin and yang party.
Why, did you ever think that we used to sing in high school would get... Oh,
Ying Party.
We're on the radio now.
Get him back in for a second. We have to talk about that email, but... We get... you...
I can...
Ladies, why are you high-fiving?
I got sort of a kind of thing.
Huh?
What? You like the Ying and Yang Party?
We used to say it all the time. Why?
Give us that again.
What?
Yang Yang Party!
Yay!
Marion just smacked Lady Di in the nose with her high five.
Well, they tried to do the high five, but you know when people can't do the high five? And they hit each other? Well, with those glasses, she can't see anything too close.
Why?
Well, give us that again.
Oh my God. Marion just smacked Lady Di in the nose with her high five.
Well, they tried to do the high five, but you know when people can't do the high five? And they hit each other? Well, with those glasses, she can't see anything too close to her head.
I got sort of a kind of a depth perception.
She's trying to call somebody. That's right.
Right. I'm not calling him now.
Put the phone down.
Oh, my God. They just...
Babo!
Guys, what kind of partying did you used to do?
Yeah, tell us about the high school party.
When you used to do the yin yang party.
That was fun. We used to do
Anthony.
That.
Open.
Party.
Party.
Faggot.
Right. Exactly.
So what kind of partying did you used to do?
Yeah, you smoked a little
Give us a little insight on a weekend night during high school.
Not
for
high
you
school.
Two.
We were 21.
We were
in our 20s.
Well, go ahead. Yeah, give us a little insight. A hot weekend coming up. Literal, what happened?
The turtle races.
Turtle races.
What are turtle races?
Turtles.
Actual turtles on a track?
Yeah.
You call them
we
certain
used to
names
go to turtle races.
I thought that was a code for like some kind of acid.
No,
you're actually talking about
turtles.
Dude, I did some turtle races last night. I was seeing melting faces.
You never heard of turtle races?
No.
They had them. They had them in Staten Island, right? They had
turtle races.
Fogarty's. They had them in Cliff.
That's your like weekend night out.
Friday night. We used to drink.
We used to party.
And you'd party. What was like? What were you doing? Tequila.
Drinking.
Hey, how many races could you see in a night?
Smoking.
Yeah.
Do a little bit of
one.
Well, I don't want to say it.
And then we do some putt-putt golf.
Do a little bit of.
If we were really out of control, we go do some putt-putt golf.
Turtle races, ladies.
Turtle races. Yes.
Slow down. What else did you used to do?
Oh, when we were crazy, we would go rock and ball. We're just wild women.
Rock and roll, wild women. We used to dance.
Why? When you guys?
We still do.
We stay out late and watch the midnight show of Laser Light Show.
No. Sometimes.
Oh we go to the planetarium and watch the Laser Light Show. Laser Floyd. Laser Floyd.
So by the end
and
of the
stay
night.
Stay up all night.
So wait a minute.
Stay up all night.
Yo, by the end of the night, the total races got to the finish line, right?
Yeah, really. How long did that take?
Yes, they did.
It took the whole night
and you want a drink.
Yeah, and you want a drink. So we used to drink on and off for free.
On a particular turtle that
you bet on. Yeah. Right.
Well, I got to get me some turtles.
The first 1/50th of the.
Imagine if Lady Di's alcoholism was born from turtle races where she won drinks.
Race in 1 hour 50 seconds, they round the far turn.
I don't think they do that anymore. They haven't done that in like 12 years.
Well, yeah.
It's gone, you know.
Something people found lives.
Man. Yeah.
What a coincidence, you know.
That was years ago. That was a long time ago.
They used
ago.
To have it like a Belmore.
That was before TV, obviously. I used to take acid and fire automatic weapons in the woods, and, you know, you'd go to turtle races.
And then after that, we used to go to her house and hang out all night.
Yeah, remember?
It was always party at Diane's apartment.
Who used to, who's the one that gave the hummers at the end of the night?
Nobody.
We went to the grass growing races.
It was me and her.
It was great. They put the seats down, water it, and we sat on.
It was me and her and another friend of ours and other people that we knew.
And
it was nobody. It was not. Ours. No picking up people. No.
You didn't get freaked
like
out.
No. No getting freaked.
All right, ladies. Which one of you farted?
Neither.
One of us.
No, you got to fess up.
Yeah. Nobody.
Who farted?
Because
actually, I still smelled it because I think it's still in one of your pants.
No, we did not.
Who farted then?
Nobody.
Who do you think farted if it wasn't you two?
Rachel said it was cigars.
No, it wasn't
cigars.
I don't know.
I don't know.
Turtle races.
Yeah.
That was your wild night out. You're talking that was yin yang party.
Every other Friday.
Yin yang party. Let's go to the turtle races.
We used to go and hang out at this bar that we grew up around a block.
Right.
We used to go there and just hang out there at 2:00.
Marion, Lady Di, listen. I need pictures. Of you guys back in your heyday, a yin yang party, Bring them in, please, because we need to have some of those.
I know you have some.
Up on
I
a website. A,
well, she has. She
what
has
are you
some.
Crazy? You bring those in. I gotta see the young.
I don't have
retarded
any.
Laverne and Shirley.
With their Farrah Fawcett hairdo.
Ying Yang party with Farrah Fawcett hairdo.
I was much thinner back then.
It was much thinner. And
you know what's
I
funny about that, Anthony?
What's up?
You know when there's always like a hairstyle that gets popular, like you know the Farrah Fawcett or the Dorothy Hamill.
I
you know,
yeah.
those haircuts aren't meant for everyone.
Right.
Sadly, I had a Farrah Fawcett, but I went with the both Eric 10 beads.
I never had beads in my hair.
You never had the beads?
I had beads in my hair.
Oh, you had the you had the 10? And what did you have? The big, the feathered? Did you have the feathered cut that you would blow dry back? Like the Farrah Fawcett?
I did that one time.
They talk at the same time. I know, they talk at the same time.
No, wait for her to finish, because you're asking her, and then you're asking me.
Mary went with the Rocky Dennis.
All right, you go first, and then I'll go second.
Oh.
All right, finish what you were saying.
In other words, we want more info on your wacky night out, but it seems like that's all you got. Now you don't recall a night of maybe... Some sex in a car or something. Oh, Marion just went yeah, little car sex, Marion.
No,
nice.
Not that.
Yeah,
not that.
A handy?
No,
a
nothing.
Handy? You give the guy the handy?
No, it was not like that.
That's a Boeing 707. Those babies really hug the sky.
Come on, Animal House.
Other, no, I was thinking about other stuff.
There goes the bell.
I was Rick thinking knows. About
Anthony.
Other stuff.
Yeah, I always wondered what Rocky Dennis would look like with a perm,
so
and now I know.
We were thinking. I was thinking about other stuff that we did.
What were you
I got sleep fit enough.
What were you smoking? Come on, say it.
What were you smoking?
Yeah, like nobody ever smoked
crack?
At point when they were in their younger.
God. Oh, so now you're out partying, you smoke a little weed out in the car.
Yeah.
And then
years
what happened?
Years ago.
Then what happened?
Don't forget, this is going back 13, 14, 15
right.
years.
Right. Yeah, this is ago. Like crazy, right. So you'd smoke a little pot. Were you with guys at the time?
No.
You're just with each other?
Yeah, and other friends.
Friends.
And other
friends. But were some of the friends guys?
Yeah.
All right. So you'd smoke some pot, and then what? Would they try to pick you up sometimes?
No.
That would make you horny. No. I don't know what kind of weed these women are smoking.
Yeah.
Hey, ladies, can we do our own turtle races? Well, we put you, you know, I put you on your back and see how long it takes you to stand the gas suit yourself.
No.
Get them turtle suits and have them run around the block.
No.
They don't need the shells.
There was a DJ there. There was a DJ there who had their own turtles.
Big whoop, who cares?
He was from, actually, from down the street.
I'm getting reports that you went with the Pat Benatar hairdo. Is that true? You went with the Pat Benatar?
No, I did one time.
You went everything.
I must have had all different hairstyles.
Hair.
My hair was
when
blonde
was
one time too.
Oh my God!
She did. She dyed her hair blonde one time.
That's right.
Wow, that's hot.
That's why your hair dyed.
That's why your hair dyed.
My hair did not dye.
No. All right. So you're smoking some pot. You're out in the car. What else? What's
my hair did not dye, guys. Lady Di's hair did not dye. I just want to make that clear.
The wildest night, you two. I know you probably got a story. What? Remember that night? Give
the
us some
that
insight.
That we ended up staying over here in Manhattan at a video place.
Well, he's talking about years ago.
Oh, that too.
Oh, that, okay.
We used to hang out.
All right.
Over here.
So you came into Manhattan. You had to stay overnight at a video place for what?
No, we just hung out.
We went to a movie.
You went to a movie.
We went. We missed the last train.
And that.
Getting back to Jersey, and we just figured, what the hell? We got 3 hours. We walked around here, Manhattan. We ended up in a video.
Ying Yang party.
We went to a porn theater.
The midnight show. You went to a porno movie.
Yeah.
All right. Now we're getting somewhere.
What was the name of the porno?
I don't remember.
Was it?
No, because
it was a film. You went in. It was a theater,
was
and you watched porno movies.
What was going on in the film?
Yeah. What was happening?
What was going on in the film?
Oh yeah, you remember.
I don't.
No, I don't live on the moon.
I remember being saying, hey, that's saran wrap.
Saran wrap.
What was
Some girls were wrapping up this guy with saran wrap and having their way with him.
Hmm. Oh, yeah?
I don't know the name of the porn
And that's store. Your wildest night out.
It was a night out over here in New York. We had a couple wild nights.
I was saying, I'm looking for the wild night of sex, drugs, and hijinks.
I want to know when Marion decided to look like a Dr. Seuss character.
Oh, there we go.
Which one she looked like, Kobe? Which one?
I don't know. It's killing me, though.
I don't know what I decided to look like, Friar Tuck.
Let me tell you,
someone's got
to...
We have pictures of Marion on the website. Someone's got to find the Dr. Seuss character she looks like, because it's
a good contest.
What character are we talking about?
Yeah, what do I look like?
Who?
Huh?
Which one?
I don't know.
No, it's not a who.
No, definitely not a who.
I don't know who.
Which Dr. Seuss character?
Back then,
you don't know?
I had long straight hair.
No.
When you guys met me last year, I had long straight hair.
Oh, we didn't even know.
I don't remember.
Wow, no. I remember when you had long hair.
I got the perm for the summer.
You got the perm for the summer.
Hey, Marion.
The perm gets cut out.
Marion, you could rest your arms on your boobs.
She was just doing that. Wow.
I could do that too.
Oh, now,
I could do that too.
Lady Di's got to go. I could do it too.
See?
Hi, how you been? Hi, Steve. Hi.
Oh, God. Everyone that walks in, they're just, hi.
All
right, ladies, thank you. We just
got ladies, thank you. And remember, bring in pictures of you in your partying heyday, your yin yang party.
I have them. I'm going to look for them.
I want all of them.
Right.
You'll get them.
Nice.
You will get them.
All right.
Well, I was about 40 pounds thinner, too.
Oh, wow. Wow. Hot.
Wow.
So bring those in.
Thank you.
Bring those in.
It was real thin.
All right, ladies. Thank you very much.
Jesus. No. I don't have any Wolverines in my apartment. There's no Wolverines over here.
You're welcome.
For whatever.
When do you want us to bring them in?
ASAP.
Whenever I could find them.
Yeah, of course. Ladies,
bring them in next week.
Thank you.
Next week?
Next Friday.
Thank you.
Next Friday.
How about in August?
No, ladies.
August.
Ladies, leave.
All right. Thank you, girls. Thank you. Thank you for leaving.
Of course you will.
For leaving.
Okay.
Please.
Take care.
Thank
bye,
you.
Guys.
Bye, retarded Laverne and Shirley. There they go.
Green eggs in hand.
Yin yang party.
Yes.
Woo! Yin yang party, Stinky.
Woo! We're going to the turtle races.
Stinky! Stinky! Yin yang party, baby!
Stinky!
Yin yang party!
Stinky! Yin yang party!
Woo!
We're going to the turtle races.
We had it say that
one. Oh, my God.
Turtle races.
Rocky Dennis with a perm. Holy smoke.
So who's upstairs?
They're out there now.
Oh.
Uh-oh. Bring him in for 1 second.
By the way, can I make one announcement? I'm sorry. I called the Stress Factory, and no one is answering the phones, which is a good way to do business, you know, 2.5 hours
before
the show. Don't answer the phones. Let the machine pick it up. You idiots.
Yeah, Norton at the Stress Factory tonight and tomorrow, right?
I don't want to give out the 732-545-HAHA number again. I've done it too many times, and that would be slutty and gratuitous.
Speaking of slutty and disgusting,
let's bring in, who is outside, the retarded Laverne and Shirley. Here they are, Marion and Lady Di. Hi, Marion, Lady Di. How are you girls today? Yeah, give them that mic over there. There you go. As far away from me as possible.
Hey.
I wonder if the Lamplight Bar has like a picture of Lady Di hanging up on the wall. Or like if any of the employees that work there now worked there then. You're just like, hey, you know Lady Di? And then they're like, they turn into like the old sailor character. He's, I've got a story to tell you.
There's a mic!
Get talking to the mic.
Here they go.
Morons.
Here they go. This is classic. These two friggin' morons.
Hi, OB. Hi, Anthony. How you guys doing? Hi.
Hi.
I'm glad you're okay from your car accident. I'm glad your girlfriend's okay, too.
We are.
Yeah.
Look at how concerned.
Lady Di. Yeah, we are.
Do you know, Lady Di, what do you do? You put a bowl on your head and give yourself a haircut?
No.
What'd you go with the dyke haircut for?
Hey, I got mine cut Wednesday. Oh, I want to
say hold on, hold on. No, I'm Lady Di. What do you do to your hair?
I had to get a trim.
You look like something out of a John Woo film.
I knew you were going to say something smart.
Chow Yun Fat Pig.
I was waiting for that.
Chow Yun Fat Pig. That was good.
They're not going to pick on you. They're going to pick on me now. It's my turn.
No, Lady Di, you cut your bangs too high.
Yeah, you cut them too high.
Wait.
And Lady Di. Lady Di, they're thinned out too much, too.
No, it's weird. Like, you see that same look on some of the supermodels that walk around Manhattan, you know, where they make their bangs way too high?
Yeah.
But in a weird way, it looks cool. You look completely retarded.
Yeah.
Okay.
I was more turned on looking
it's
at dialysis arm.
It's going to grow out.
Hey, Opie, Anthony, what happened to the Plenty Up Top lady? We were hoping to see her.
Oh,
yeah, we were hoping.
Really?
We heard it before, but...
Well, we have a lot on top.
I have too
no,
much up here.
No, on you it's on called top. Plenty downtime.
I have too much up here.
I don't know where the boobs end and the bunt begins.
Hey, did you hit your head in a car accident?
Yeah, I did. Why?
How you doing? Oh. Hey, how you doing? Really, all right?
What, are you making fun of a car accident?
No, we don't do that.
What was that?
When I was 21, so
what was that?
I'm glad that you're okay.
What happened to you at 21?
I was in a car accident.
And what happened?
I'm not saying. I broke my arm.
You broke your arm, and what else?
I broke my arm.
Broke your arm?
Yeah.
What else happened?
That's it.
Hey, let me see your arm. What happened? Is that from it?
Yeah.
So you were born with that face.
No, I did. I mean, it's no big deal. I'm 37 now, so it doesn't bother me. I want to say hi to Danielle. The one that does my hair. I'm going to say hi to the corner bar.
Who cares?
Franny and George. Who do we meet with?
What else?
Gary. Is that her name? His name Gary?
Lenny Squiggy.
Who are we met last Friday?
And
hello?
Hello?
Gary.
Ying Yang Party.
Ying Yang Party.
Hey, Mary.
We went out last
Mary,
week.
Shut up. Did you get your hair done again?
I got it cut Wednesday.
It's awful. It's horrible.
No, it ain't.
It's everything. Don't show up.
You guys are ugly enough. You're making yourselves look uglier.
No, we're not.
What are you doing? Your bangs are too short and her hair's too tight again. Your perm was starting to loosen up and now it's tight again.
It's starting to get too long.
Your hair looks like a used Brillo pad.
No, it's starting to get too long, so I had to get a trim.
It's tight.
No, it's not tight.
It is.
I got it cut.
I know cancer patients that wouldn't walk around with that hair.
I got it. That's your hair.
No.
You got it.
Lady Di, why did you dyke yourself up with that hair, though?
I got a trim, so this way.
No, that's not a trim.
Who cut your bangs like that?
My hairdresser.
You know what hairdo that is?
Oh, my God. She's got the hairdo from...
From where?
I'll tell you who it is.
Go ahead.
From where?
It's Mary from the Little Rascals.
Hey, Opie Anthony.
Mary from remember
Little
Mary?
Rascals. Okay, yeah, I remember.
Hey, remember when we were here?
I was thinking that actress, Rossellini.
Isabella Rossellini?
Isabella Rossellini.
Remember when we were here
a
few weeks ago? You want pictures of us?
No.
When we were younger? We brought them younger.
Bring them over. Get them right to me. Right to me.
Wait, not to you.
Just give them to me.
I got two pictures in here.
Well, Jesus Christ, you're taking forever.
No, these are the ones.
Give them to me.
The pictures out.
They're a road show.
Let me see.
Rick, just give me those right away. I got to see the young Lady Di and Marion pictures. Oh, no. Oh, there's the young Lady Di. Lady Di, you were never a thin girl, were you?
Yes, I was.
You were never a thin girl.
What's the sore on the lip? Look at the sore on the
Marion lip. Looks exactly the same.
Let me see.
Look at Marion. She looks exactly the same. Marion.
Wait, no, Anthony. I was heavier. In those pictures.
Oh, my dear sweet Jesus. Look at this 80s look she's got.
She looks like Tommy Shaw.
Too much fat on my bones.
We told you guys she was heavier.
Oh, my God.
All right, hold on. Anthony, I got another one. She looks like Tommy Shaw, and Lady Di looks like a fat Ralph Macchio.
Let me see that picture. That's a horrible picture of me. That is a horrible picture.
Diane has hers.
A little bit after I had my son. I don't like that picture.
All right, I'm looking at maybe a thinner Lady Di.
Yes, that's right. Those are the better ones.
Okay.
Those are the better
looking
ones.
Looking at a thinner Lady Di.
They're the ones that I found. We were able to. You got one. She has one,
yes,
too.
I do.
Wow, Lady Di, you still look like that? I'll give you some props.
I'd have thrown you a banging back then.
I might have thrown you a banging back then.
I was into the monkeys when I was 22 years old.
You would have, huh?
I'm gonna look like one.
No.
Wow, and look at Marion in this one, holding up her beer with her little stripe.
Hey, we're the drunkies. Sorry, I got to take off a little earlier than I expected. So, going to end the stream here at, what is it? Actually kind of works out about 3 hours in. All right. So, cool. Thank you guys for joining and watching. I'm going to take off. I'm going to play some sleeves on the way out. Take it easy, guys.
Sherwin sleeves.
It could
Sherwin
be a good
sleeves.
Song.
I'm a big fan of Sherwin.
I don't hate the la la la. What I hate about it is
where it should be a better. I don't know what I don't like about it, but I have a weird, like, I kind of like the song and I kind of hate it.
I hate it.
I'm like the child of both of these two parents here.
Oh, look at you.
This is going to lead up to Sherwin Sleeves calling our show and explaining the song.
Oh, I am curious.
But today what we got, Sleeves saw you, heard you yesterday.
Beating, oh, did
up,
he?
Beating up his fucking song.
He listens
song.
To the program?
Yes, he does.
I didn't know that.
Sherwin Sleeves is a fan.
Hi, Sleeves.
I think he's a bigger fan of Ron Fez, and that's fine with
I
us.
I like the Mighty Horse Rocks. I like I like that fucking song.
I like his sledding video, but I think he might have taken it down because I can't see it anymore.
I don't know. Well, yeah, but this Christmas song thing, you know, Sleeves, sorry.
Really?
I ain't buying it. I'm not buying into the hype that it's so profound and means so many things to so many different people. I don't see it as being that. I see it as being too specific, the lead up to the la-la-la-la. So the la-la-la-la is like, it's like you fucking, your song is Mad Libs.
Have you ever been?
It's Mad Libs song. Feeling pretty good in the house. I need a noun. Give me a verb. Making my way to the la 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 train station. Fuck Sleeves.
I like talking about family stuff because people can relate. That's really the reason I do it. Because maybe I should keep this shit to myself. But Rob in Chicago writes, "Hey, Ope, at least you got the joy of tearing into gifts. As far as I can remember, I had to carefully open gifts so we could reuse the wrapping paper."
Oh, God, reuse the wrapping paper. Oh, watch it. Watch how you're taking the tape off.
The joy of just tearing away was great.
You want to rip that apart as a kid.
Feeling pretty good.
Feeling pretty good.
Well, you don't like Sleeves, do you?
I don't like Sleeves' Christmas song. I don't know the Sleeves as a man.
The Sleeves?
I don't know
as
him
a
as a gentleman.
Is a very talented man.
I don't genuine
man.
I'm not buying into the hype of that fucking Christmas song like everyone else does.
Well, he
Stop it.
So you don't want to hear the song he made for you today?
Great.
He made a Christmas song for you, Anthony.
Did he?
Did he really?
Yes, he did.
Spaghetti on the wall, la 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 la. Put the doll down, faggots, la 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 la. Get on the bus, boy, la 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 la. You're gonna run to the store, get some more Captain Morgan. You're gonna hide in a bush, Mexican hog in your mouth, fa la la la. Lick the guy sets you up. Pops out with his wife, la 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 la,
la 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 la.
Sex with a hooker at 13, la la.
All of a sudden, best friend wants to blow you, la 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 la.
Jeep, 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 la la la. Keep your eyes closed. Richard taps you on the back.
See, you guys love the song. Secretly, yeah, you love
no.
the song.
Yeah.
Want to hear your Christmas song from Sherwin?
I don't see as how I got much of a choice, but
here
let's
we go.
Hear what Sherwin does.
KTEL and Columbia House present Ho, 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 Three Hooers.
This fucking guy has a great voice, by the way.
It's odd.
It's a great voice.
It's an odd voice.
He should be
voice.
Telling stories somewhere.
Yeah?
Yes, he's got that
stories.
Storytelling voice.
He does.
It was a very coomier Christmas. Got your gun for Christmas. Too bad you died of AIDS. Insert a rogue joke here. Featured all your favorite Yule logs. She might have been 10, she might have been 20. I couldn't tell, I was completely drunk. I went outside to piss in the snow, and I pissed on Santa Claus. Hey, Santa. On a naughty list now. Old chestnuts. My hair plugs roasted by the fire. I'll keep my baseball hat on for a little while. And there would be no coomier Christmas without a little la la. I was living near the Jews. La 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 la. Plugging in my hair with la la la. Eating all the blacks with la 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 la. Shooting up my guns with la 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 la. Live from the compound, la la. Ho, ho, ho. Three hoas. A very coomier Christmas.
Holy shit. How do you not love them now?
That's great.
All right, that's
you gotta
fucking,
love Sherwin now.
Very
that's
funny.
That's fucking funny.
That is so fucking good. I want my own now. I want one, Sherwin. I want one. And Jimmy wants
no,
one.
No, Jimmy doesn't.
Jimmy, you want a no. Sleeves Christmas song.
Yeah, holy put on 15 shit. Pounds, la, 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 la. Fucking coattail rider now, la, 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 la. Third mic bag of shit. I'll do it for you. Miss Bill Burr now, la, 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 la. Wish you were in L.A. taping, la, la. Fuck that. I don't need my own.
Wow, I gotta say.
Your own.
I gotta say, I think...
You're a fan
after
now.
All this,
you're
no,
a fan.
No, no, I think after all this time, I may have hit a nerve with Sleeves. No, I think after all the years of bashing his Christmas song.
I think
song,
he's shown that he's got a sense of humor, my friend.
I think I might have
that
hit
la, la,
a nerve.
That la-la-la-la line is yeah, classic.
The la-la-la-la-la-la-la. He la-la'd the la-la's.
Why do you think that he was just getting angry and singing real stuff? Sorry that you had a bad childhood, la-la. Sorry that you hate your own guts now, la-la. You have a drinking problem, la 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 la. You're gonna be killed drunk driving, la la. Hope your gun goes off and kills you, la 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 la. Hope blacks rape you, la 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 la. The Jews don't like you either.
He was getting a little real there.
Shitty mustache like Raul Julia, la la. That was just me singing.
I know. I'm trying to get rid of it.